never in a happy mood, so. Should be a fun show. There he is.
Oh.
Oh, better late than never.
Better late than never.
Join us, won't you?
Oh.
Here he is, folks. Your leader, Ryan Clark.
Better late than never.
Yes.
How are we doing?
I'm told him when neither one of us are in a particularly good mood. We're both tired, and you're real pissed about the weather, so.
No, it came around today.
Not like it was supposed to.
I'm tired.
Yeah.
I'm tired.
You're tired of this bullshit with the weather?
Yeah.
Come on,
man.
You gotta wake up.
Yeah, it's been, you know. I mean, we'll get into it here in just a second. First of all, how we doing?
Hello.
WZR Army. Tuesday night, yeah. Time for WZR TV Tuesday's post-Royal Rumble show. We all have to talk about tonight. A lot to talk about with a blizzard here in the Northeast, which has driven me crazy. Drove me crazy, man.
It almost got you knocked out at about 1 in the morning.
You
woke me up like 3 times. Every time I fall asleep, I get woken up with a fuck! Fuck!
You know what it was?
Loud as shit.
The models were coming in last night, and the Euro model came out last night at about 1:30 a.m., just prior to 1:30, and when I saw the Euro, I saw the GFS earlier in the night, around 10 o'clock, and I said to myself, this ain't looking good, man, it's trending east, and then the Euro came out and verified that everything was trending east, and then we had dry air in place, which just made it even worse. So, you know, the Euro came out, and I just thought, like, you know what I did? I stayed up last night until about 3:30.
All right.
Went to my bed, laid down, got to sleep around 4 a.m., picked up about 2 hours of sleep, and then my sister, who was up every single morning, got me up this morning at about 5:45 a.m., and I was on Facebook by 6. I put an update. I think I put the Facebook update at about 5:58 a.m.
So you're running off 2 hours of sleep.
Yeah.
I can't inject a lot of energy when you're doing a speech. You don't want to interrupt and you're talking like this.
Yeah.
There's not a lot I can do to bring energy when you do that. So
you
told me to bring the rubber.
Let me tell you. So let me run it down. First of all. All
right. Now you sound good.
First of all.
Run it down.
What we're going to do tonight is the same format that we used last week, where we're going to do the news and the rumors
notes.
And everything else. Now, normally we would come on here and we'd have a pay-per-view to run down once a month on pay-per-view.
Normally we'd have Raw to run down.
Right. Normally we would have Raw. There wasn't much going on Raw last night as they aired the entire Royal Rumble pay-per-view match, which was an hour.
And the Triple Threat.
And the Triple Threat match was
20.
Another half hour.
Yeah.
So
the commercials, 30, yeah.
Right. So you had commercials in the Royal Rumble match and the WWE title match. You had all the stuff on Raw last night, and then they would shoot back to the studio.
So it was basically 4 segments that mattered.
Yeah.
Interviews. Other than that,
a lot
just,
of stuff.
Other than that, it was just Cole and Booker bullshitting.
Right.
Like a pre-show.
Pretty much.
But the actual angles that were shot were all done with It was almost like Michael Cole's weekly sit-down interview.
Right.
Only
exactly.
Sometimes it would be Renee Young, who cut her hair all off, I noticed. Michael Cole.
She's still hot.
She's still smoking
she's
hot.
She's still hot.
Yeah, very hot. But so there was the 4 interviews. Dean Ambrose did a little comedy thing at the end. So they still found a way to do a comedy bit.
Right.
Even when they can't do a show, they still found a way
well,
to do a
Well, Reigns was good last night, though. Reigns.
I'm talking about Ambrose.
Oh, Ambrose.
The combo.
Ambrose,
the comedy at the end, you might have missed it. He was talking about how he hitchhiked his way here. And
yeah, I saw from the outside. He was outside.
Yeah,
But, so anyways, so we're going to talk the Royal Rumble. I mean, that's something that we can run down pretty much from top to bottom. There's only about 5 matches on that show anyway.
If that, yeah, yeah.
Yeah, but yeah, I mean, the Royal Rumble match takes up an entire hour.
Yeah,
pretty
least.
Much anyways.
At
and
least.
Got, I mean, we got to talk about Roman Reigns and the reaction that Reigns got.
And all that, yeah.
Some of the spots that they had in the Rumble as they do, you know,
Rock.
Every year. So, so in addition to that, probably do that at the end of hour number one and continue into hour number two. Also, got my trusty notes this week.
Let's see, let's see if they remember last week's handwriting. Let's see if they can tell who wrote it this week. A lot cleaner.
No, wait a minute.
Yeah.
You told me.
I did have trouble with the letters.
That you were having trouble writing this.
Somewhere around the.
You think this is better? Yeah, it is better than mine.
A little better. I'm still not a great handwriter, but.
It's better than mine.
It's readable. It's legible, as they say.
So, anyway, we're going to talk about all the latest news and rumors from the past week. Give you guys a quick preview, real quick. Justin Gabriel quit WWE over the past week. We're going to do a WWE Network announcement today.
Big announcement.
Hit 1 million subscribers today on the network. Talk about Finn Balor, Prince Devitt, possibly injured. Bubba Ray Dudley returned during the Royal Rumble. What else? WWE stock with the network announcement skyrocketed
today. It's
kind of
hand in hand with the network.
And then the Raw rating comes out from last night, and boom! I mean, it's better than most weeks.
It was the best number in months.
Also going to talk about TNA's Destination America deal. A little bit of TNA news for you. How long is that deal for? Going to talk about that.
He skips right over the UFC. There was some pretty
big
cool
names.
UFC.
We're going to talk UFC. Right. Big names. We're also backstage at the Royal Rumble. Some of them, a lot of them, weren't used. Everybody that was backstage that was.
Yeah.
And why did they do it? We're going to talk about that. And why would they have these guys?
That's not why they were there, but they were hoping.
We'll get into it. The WrestleMania 32 location confirmed for Dallas, Texas. WrestleMania 33,
Arlington, Dallas. We talked about that last time, by the way. A&T, we made the same comment about Arlington.
We're talking about Dallas. Everybody says Dallas, but WrestleMania 33 looks like it's going to be Philadelphia. So we're going to talk about that. It's pretty.
They want it.
Yeah. They want it bad.
But they wanted it 32, too.
Raw and SmackDown television tapings this week canceled, which I'm going to get into here in just a second. I had a long rant about this storm.
Is this true?
So.
Marnelli? Fandango was fired?
I have not heard that unless it just recently.
Oh, no, Jerichoholic. It was a joke since Justin Gabriel looked like Fandango. Get over to the chat room, WZROnline.com.
Motherfucking.com/chat. See, I still got my game to sleep.
He's still sharp, folks.
All right. I got it.
Comedians in there screwing up the flow. We love you guys.
And SmackDown's going to air live this Thursday night. What's going to happen on SmackDown? Are we going to get from Hartford?
So if you bought a ticket to Raw, you go to SmackDown.
You go to SmackDown.
And pretty much SmackDown will be Raw because everything that
it looks like the original script for Raw looks like it's going to be used.
We talked about that yesterday.
SmackDown.
When a big pay per view like Rumble or WrestleMania, they tend to write not the whole show and they do the rewrites later, whatever. But they have like a good idea of where they want to go the next night on Raw.
Well, if there is one show you don't want to miss,
yeah.
It's the show after the Royal Rumble.
After the WrestleMania. But Royal Rumble also.
Yeah.
Well, even maybe more so Royal Rumble. Not with Fastlane now.
Because
why do they have a pay-per-view wedged in between Rumble and Mania? That's a whole other thing.
I know.
But because, like you said, a post-Rumble Raw is one you don't want to miss because that's where you know...
Yes.
That's where you know where we're going for the biggest show of the year.
Absolutely. So, that wasn't the one you wanted.
But the ratings proved something. They proved
that they should do that every week.
Well, not
same formula.
Well, listen, it was very effective. And we'll get into all this as we get going. We're just doing previews right now. But I'm just saying the ratings proved more than, because they aired the Rumble and Raw. Or maybe that was why. But it proved more that, everybody was saying when I read the feedback from the rating posts, everybody was like, well, the number was going to be huge anyway because it's the post-Rumble Raw. People are going to tune in. Mm-hmm. But it's a 3-hour show. The question was, could they make
it?
Obviously, the first hour is going to be nice because that first quarter hour is going to be real high.
Oh, yeah.
Everybody's tuning in.
See what they're going to do. What are they going to do tonight with it being...
Well, that, and you want to know what happened a lot of times.
Yeah.
Like, when I was a kid, I always tuned in right after the pay-per-view, be like, who won? What happened?
Right.
What did it look like? What did it feel like?
Yeah.
So, but they kept those viewers. Hour two grew from hour one. So, everybody watching that first hour knew, we're not in an arena this week. We're not having an actual show.
Exactly.
But they still stuck. They wanted to see what... Well, they know we're doing
something. What are they going to do? Right.
They were smart, and they advertised at the top of the hour, we're going to talk to Roman Reigns and Brock Lesnar and you know.
Do you know... I didn't look closely enough. I remember typing it, but I can't... Did it go... The third hour, was it down from the first hour or up?
Third hour is the hour that dropped.
But the first hour, and then it rose the second hour.
Yeah.
And then the third hour, it dropped back down.
Yeah. Okay. But that's right, always happens. Right. That always happens because kids got to go to bed and shit.
True.
Yeah, because you're talking 10 to 11 p.m. I mean, when I was a kid, I had to be in bed by 10.
Right.
And I had
right.
very, very lenient parents.
Right.
You know what I mean?
Right.
You know that, but, you know what I mean? Passing the pipe around when you're 12 years old, you know, you got to see your parents. And I'm not talking about a marijuana pipe, by the way.
We're going to talk about The Undertaker, Arnold Schwarzenegger to the WWE Hall of Fame. We're going to talk about The Undertaker at WrestleMania 31, and then before I get into this rant about the Storm, okay.
Well, also, we're going to talk about UFC.
UFC.
Okay, is that where you're going?
Also, before I get into the Storm, this rant that I'm about to go on about this Storm, we had a UFC event on Sunday night.
And somebody lost some money.
Yeah.
This guy right here.
We didn't want to bet.
We didn't want to bet, but we did bet.
We shook
hands and everything. There was three main events. UFC on Fox. The numbers for that also were one of the best ratings UFC
I heard that, right? Yeah. Fox
didn't touch Conor McGregor's numbers.
Yeah.
That was Fox Sports 1 against the UFC Championship.
Oh, no, I'm thinking about Conor McGregor.
Was the record breaker. Fox was Gustafson, Anthony Johnson, Dan Anderson.
It did good numbers?
The numbers were good,
yeah.
All right. Real good.
Okay.
They were in Stockholm, Sweden, close to 30,000 people. It might have been the second largest UFC crowd in history. So
28,000 people?
Upwards of 28. I don't even know. Yeah, no, official number. It was like 28-something. But yeah.
It didn't look like it was sold out. Or was that the Rumble? There was one where
Rumble
I said
was sold
to you.
Out, right?
Well, I had said to you, one of these events doesn't look sold out.
You said the Sweden event.
It was UFC.
Yeah.
Right.
And it was reported that it was a close sellout. I don't think it did sell out, though, when it was all said and done.
Right.
Even with the papering, or the comp
it
tickets.
It still drew 25, 26, 27,000 people.
Yeah, it was still a huge house. I mean, second biggest in history
right.
of UFC.
Right. So the main event, Alexander Gustafsson, man.
Gustafsson got wrecked.
Yeah. I heard he was crying after the fight.
There's a video, MMAnews.com. There's a video of main event was Alexander Gustafsson versus Anthony Johnson. This was basically, I don't want to say a gimme fight, but
Anthony
it was
Rumble.
Anthony Rumble Johnson, which Booker T would
like
point out.
The Royal Rumble.
Yeah, Booker T pointed that out on the pre-show.
Remember? Anthony Rumble Johnson.
He wedged the UFC plug in.
He did.
Rumble. But it was basically like a fight designed to give Gustafsson one final before he does the rematch with Jon Jones. UFC fans, MMA fans will remember, Jones and Gustafsson had like an epic fight, you know, like one of the best fight in UFC light heavyweight division history.
Right.
Amazing war, the only guy to ever really challenge Jon Jones and give him a fight where at the end you're like, oh God, I don't even know who won, it was so close.
Yeah.
Some people thought Gustafsson won, some people thought Jones won.
Right.
And since then, Jones fought DC, got the win, in a pretty, you know, dominant performance, I would say, from Jones, but Gustafsson had already knocked out Jimmy Manoa, a top 10 ranked guy, and because Jones, if you remember, Jones and DC was supposed to happen in September, so because it got postponed, Gustafsson said, fuck it, I'll take another fight. UFC matched him up with Anthony Johnson, who was no joke at all, by the way. It was a very risky fight, and as it turned out, it was too risky, but the point being, they designed that fight to give Gustafsson one final big fucking, let's get him make him a bigger name.
Make him a bigger star than what he already is.
In his home country of Sweden, where he was a fucking rock star, like Conor McGregor in Ireland, or GSP in Canada, or Brett Hart in Canada. It was like that kind of a atmosphere, where the crowd was completely electric, came specifically to see Gustafsson win, and he got knocked out in the first round.
He got knocked out.
Not only was it like a lucky punch and all he went down.
No.
He got battered and then knocked out.
He got hit and then Johnson jumped on top of him.
Well, even just he got hit, he was getting nailed the whole
fight. He was coming up and in, up and in, and it was just blows.
But I don't want to make it seem like he got caught, went down, and then Johnson pounded him.
No,
he hit him, hurt him. Gustafsson recovered. He hit him again, hurt him. Like, he was just beating his ass all over the cage. Finally knocked him down.
Not the place you want that to happen.
Very, very bad. And Jones got a lot of shit after the fight, because as soon as the fight was over,
Jones went on Twitter.
He put on Twitter, he put, not impressed, Alex.
Yeah. But he quickly deleted it,
deleted it. And then today the story came out that he explained it. Somebody asked him, why'd you do that and delete it? And he said, I'm just paying Gustafsson back for what he said. And
it's
true, Gustafsson went on Facebook when Jones beat Cormier 2 weeks ago.
He said, not impressed. I still remember that.
He did the exact GSP. It's a famous quote from GSP when he was going to fight Matt Hughes for the second time.
Okay.
They asked GSP to go in the cage to help promote the fight with him and Hughes, the rematch. And GSP, it was after Hughes beat Penn.
Right.
And their rematch. And Hughes barely won that fight. I mean, he won by TKO, but he was getting his ass kicked up until the TKO.
Right.
So GSP goes in the cage, and they say, you know, oh, you're fighting Hughes next. What do you think? And GSP gets on the mic and says, I am not impressed by your performance.
And that quote
became epic.
Yeah.
Everybody says it.
Right.
Gustafson, word for word, went on Facebook and said, I am not impressed by your performance.
He said
the exact same thing, jokingly. And he didn't delete his.
Right.
And Jones won.
Right.
Gustafson lost, was crying in his home country, and Jones posted, I'm not impressed, Alex, and then deleted it. So Jones did like a scumbag thing. Gustafson did like a funny, let's promote a fight thing.
You know, I watch John Jones interviews, and, you know, I thought that, you know, he came out this past week, and he basically said that, listen, I fucked up, and, you know, I was at a party, and I did a line of coke, and I fucked up. I thought that he was being legitimately honest. But every week, it's like there's one thing after another with John Jones, and we come on here, and you always tell me, Jones is so fake, bro.
He's fake.
He's fake, fake, fake. And I've always been against you. And the more that stuff like this happens, or he goes on Twitter,
he shows his true self, then deletes it.
It seems like he's fake, and I don't know, man.
I mean, part of it's real. You know, he really wants to be a true martial artist, and he believes in God, and all this. He wants to be a role model for kids, and he wants to be the good guy, but he can't help himself. He's a cocky, fucking arrogant, like he's like Floyd Mayweather, only without the volume turned up.
Right.
Like, if Floyd Mayweather was being himself, that's John Jones. Because Floyd Mayweather is not really like what you see. That's him knowing he's playing a character and turning it up to fucking rile people up.
I think Mayweather is pretty much what
he's very close to that. But
he's
pretty fucking close.
Mayweather
is the same
big,
way
man.
As Stone Cold Steve Austin is Stone Cold Steve Austin.
True.
But when he's not in front of a camera, he's not, oh, hell yeah, fuck you, blah, blah, this and that. That's really who he is. But
he's
when
pretty
he's
close.
Exactly.
Right,
but when
right.
he's in front of the camera, he turns it up.
Right.
When Floyd Mayweather's in front of the camera, he turns it up. When Jones is in front of the camera, he tries to turn it down because he thinks he'll come off as a nice, good guy,
exactly.
a role model.
Exactly.
And that's just not,
and it's
who
not
he
working.
Is.
And,
well,
and,
that's not
and
who
UFC
is.
Fans know it. They know it. So
because he does shit like this where he gives glimpses of who he really is.
And then
fucking
takes it down or,
and then takes
or
it down or
spins it.
Or tries to say, oh, I didn't mean it. I was really trying to say this. It just comes off that he's fake.
It does.
You
know? You're right.
But anyways, all right, so Gustafson got knocked out. Dan Anderson, unfortunate situation for Dan.
That was a terrible stoppage by the ref, man.
Dana White said it was a good stoppage.
Listen, Dan got hit. All right, he went down to the ground, and the referee almost immediately, and there were a couple punches on the ground. But the referee jumped in and stopped it.
He jumped in immediately. Unfortunately, when Dan was starting to get up,
Dan immediately said, "You got to be kidding me, right now. I'm fine."
He's been in wars. You got to give a guy like that a chance.
And you see, I mean, I saw Dan, and I understand somebody gets knocked to the ground, and immediately they get up and they say, "What are you doing? What are you doing right now?" And a lot of times they're legitimately hurt.
Yeah.
I don't think Dan was legit hurt.
His eye was fucked up. He even said himself after the fight.
I think he was okay, though.
Well, he said after the fight, at the press conference, not in the cage, because he was still all emotional.
Right.
At the press conference, he said the referee actually saved my eye, because my eye was really fucked. And he had his whole eye was taped up.
I think he could have gone.
His whole eye was taped.
Yeah, I think.
Like, he taped his whole eye shut, because it was that bad.
I still think he could have gone longer.
So he couldn't see.
And like you said, he's been in wars.
That's the point in his favor. Like, yeah, a guy like that, where they say with a referee, he just shouldn't care. If there's 2 seconds left in the round and the guy's getting hit, oh, he should let him go because there's only 2 seconds left. The referee is not supposed to give a fuck
right.
or even pay attention to the clock. He should be watching the action, and if it looks bad, he stops it.
Mm-hmm.
If there's 2 seconds left, oh well, that's the way the cookie crumbles.
Right.
But with Dan Henderson, first of all, that wasn't an issue. But why I say that is because you should also know the fighter you're being a referee for. A guy like Dan Henderson's been in wars.
He can go.
He can take more punishment than what we saw. Should he?
The punch didn't look that bad.
But he was down and he was getting hit. So the question is, should you allow him to take punishment and assume that he can come out of it?
Right.
Or do you, thinking he's fucking damn near 50 years old, he's been beating the head a lot, he might be fucking, you know, Freddie Roach, Muhammad Ali, Michael J. Fox kind of thing.
Right.
Let's stop that, you know, because it looks bad. I don't know, but sometimes with a fighter, you need to give him the benefit of the doubt.
Right.
You need to know who you're refereeing. Dan Henderson's the kind of guy where you don't jump in like that quick.
And the
Ryan Bader
beat
Phil Davis in a very boring
fight.
It was a split decision.
So that was UFC on Fox.
Fox Sports
on, on Sunday night.
Saturday night
is what it was.
Conor McGregor was Sunday.
All right. So here we go. We're going to get into this news and rumors. We're going to talk Monday Night Raw. It's all wrestling pretty much from this point forward. We're going to talk about the Royal Rumble, last night's Raw. We're going to get into this news and rumors. But I got you got to let me vent.
I got this anyway, so go ahead and do your
letter. All right. Let me vent, man. Let me just go on a quick rant. So on Saturday, I went on Facebook, and I'm viewing the models, the weather models, and I see that a clipper system is coming across that drops south of here in Albany, across Pennsylvania. It hits the coast. When it gets to the coast, it wants to wind itself up and turn into a coastal low. And the models at this point are showing a major, major snowstorm, which it was, by the way, just not for some of you. So, I go on Facebook, and I said, listen, there's talk, you know, there could be a major snowstorm come Monday and Tuesday. Put it up on Facebook, a lot of people say, wait a minute, my local weather guy's saying 1, 2, 3 inches, what are you talking about? I said, guys, wait until the evening newscast, you guys are going to see, they're going to change their forecast. That's what happened. The GFS, the Euro, the NAM. They're all, one of them has it going east, one of them has it hugging the coast, another one has it coming way west. So nothing is in agreement. We get to yesterday, Monday, well, the storm is basically knocking on the door and it's snowing. The GFS has got one run, the Euro's got another run, and the NAM, normally these models come into agreement. There was no agreement whatsoever. So you basically had to pick a model. The Euro and the NAM agreed with each other, giving a major, major snowstorm for New York City, Boston, the entire Northeast. So, with two models in agreement, one model, kind of hit or miss, and it's the GFS. Normally, the Euro and the NAM...
What's the GTS? The go-to-sleep is what it's called.
Normally, the Euro and the NAM are the most reliable models, especially the NAM, when you get close to a storm. So, we get going yesterday.
Yeah, scoot over. Look at me.
We get going yesterday, all right? And the storm starts coming together, and all of a sudden, there's a ton of dry air that's in the Northeast around New York City and Albany. So the precipitation is being thrown in off the ocean, but there's so much dry air that it's sucking it up. So the snow has fallen about 10,000 feet up there, but it's not reaching the ground. Or it's reaching the ground, but it's becoming very light. So everybody starts saying, uh-oh, something's going on here, right? Dry air, system's tracking a little bit further east. It's about 75 to 100 miles further east.
The GTS,
uh-oh,
the Euro.
Uh-oh, what's going on? Man. So during Raw last night, I made a post on my weather site. Don't want to talk about it, but made a post, put it up, and you know, and I said basically there's a lot of dry air. This thing has trended 75 to 100 miles more east. That's not to say that Boston is still not going to get crushed. The last I checked, Boston had 29 inches of snow, and it was still coming down. It was still coming down. Now, New York City, which was forecast to get close to 2 feet.
It's big.
New York City was supposed to get close to 2 feet. Long Island got crushed. I mean, Long Island has 20 to 25 inches of snow.
It's like 2 feet.
Now, you head over to Central Park, Manhattan.
Yeah.
I mean, listen, Queens, which is one of the boroughs of New York City, had 16 inches.
Five boroughs.
You go over to Manhattan, and they only had 8 inches, 8, 9 inches. So a difference between...
What the fuck is that?
It's a car out there, huh?
UFO?
So a difference between, I think it's 20 miles from Queens to Manhattan, you're going from 16 inches to 8 inches.
How many miles?
So about 20 miles.
So that close together is that different?
Like, is that
like
different?
Like this here and
is,
that there.
Is that different? And Long Island, which is, you know, maybe 50 miles away, if that, not even 50 miles, you know, they had 25 inches out in Long Island. They got crushed.
That close together.
So it was just, you know, a difference of 25, 30, 40, 50 miles made a huge difference. Yeah. So up here, we wake up this morning and we've got about an inch and a half.
On top of like the two or three we already had.
So right, right.
We got but 4 or 5 inches out there right now, right?
We've got right now, we got 6 today,
okay.
And the 2 that were on there. So anyways,
all right, so.
Finally this morning, the air was able to saturate enough, and we got some vans thrown back in Albany, so we wound up with 6 inches here in Albany, on top of the 2, 3 that we already had.
Yep. I'm ignoring
Come on, Al! So, how does that happen? How does that happen?
Every week.
So we had that, and we got about 6 inches. So we got about 8 or 9 inches on the ground right now, which is, we could have done better, but I was forecasting, for Albany, I was forecasting 8 to 16. We wound up with about 6, so I had to lower the mouse.
So you're now, wrong.
I was wrong, and everybody else was wrong, and I apologize.
He don't like me.
I apologize for being wrong. But before I move on.
Okay.
So.
Tomorrow.
I told you. A clipper system came down, and I'm going to break it to you right now. Actually, I put it up on Facebook.
He's going to break news about our local weather.
But,
stay tuned,
no,
guys,
the entire Northeast.
What about all those European guys we got?
The entire Northeast.
Okay.
I'm talking
entire
about.
Northeast.
We got a lot of Northeast fans listening.
All right.
So anyways, so this storm, what happened is a clipper system, Alberta Clipper, came out from Canada, came down, hit the coast. The latest model trends for today.
What do they say?
Show the exact same thing. Identical. I'm telling you, it's identical. It comes out of Canada,
Mickey
a
and
clipper.
Three identical.
It crosses Pennsylvania
Jimmy
on
and
Thursday.
Identical. Yes.
It crosses Pennsylvania on Thursday. It hits the coast on Thursday night. Thursday night and Friday, what does that storm do? Nobody wants to say anything, including myself. Nobody wants to say anything about it because it could turn into another bust again. But I'm telling you right now, Thursday night and Friday we need to watch. After that. Next Monday and Tuesday.
Monday and Tuesday.
Could happen again.
Whoa.
That's it.
Whoa,
I'm done.
Really?
So my apologies for.
Spencer wants to know what the local traffic report is in Albany.
Well, listen, for those that don't know, I.
Oh, they actually had a bet on how long you were going to babble about weather. That's funny.
For those that don't know, I run a weather site. I have a separate .com website for weather, on Facebook as well, this, that, and the other thing. But I don't mix the two, wrestling and weather. I want weather fans to stay weather fans. I want wrestling fans to...
I didn't know there was weather fans until I met you.
Be weather people, or wrestling people. So I don't mix the two. I've never given out the links. I'm not going to give out the links, but... A side job, so when big storms like this hit, I have to manage both weather and pro wrestling, and it's tough to do. A lot of times with big storms like this, I don't get a lot of sleep.
No, he doesn't. I can get back to that.
I didn't have any
sleep. I got a legitimate question. You're going to think I'm fucking with you.
Yes.
You're weather fans. All right, maybe you're a specific kind of weather fan, snow, but is there fans of like rain? And like
I cover everything. I do a daily forecast.
Are you excited about rain? Oh, we're gonna get a big rainstorm today.
Because
it gets like that with snow. Like he gets, guys, it's snowing.
Not
like, he
not
gets happy.
Not with rain, but I'll track the storm and I will let people know
right.
What's
so
gonna happen.
Interesting rain, but not exciting.
I track thunderstorms. We track everything.
Right.
My the weather site.
Track. I'm talking
everything.
About weather fans. Do people actually get like you get with snow with rain or sleet or? Or like, oh, it's going to be really humid today. Oh, I'm so excited
right.
For humidity.
We
really?
Do. We
wow.
Do a daily. There's a daily forecast on
these people
on,
love it.
On the weather site,
right.
And we do. We do a bunch
each
of different
own,
things.
Each his own, man.
So.
Each his own.
Anyway, so
different
I'm big into weather. If you didn't know,
folks.
Big into weather. And I've got a weather site and a Facebook page and everything else. But anyways, all right. So here we go. Let's get into pro wrestling. Let's get into pro. Watch Thursday night and Friday. I'm telling
yes.
You guys. I'm warning you guys. And not only that, but I was the guy to tell these people on Saturday when their local people were saying 1, 2, 3 inches.
Yeah.
Not only that, but people are acting like this is a major bust. Boston got 30 inches of snow. New York City got 8, 10 inches, something like that.
Listen, 8 inches is nothing.
That's
to
nothing.
Thumb your nose
I mean, that's
at. We
pretty,
still got the trucks
that's
out
pretty
there
good deal.
Clearing the roads every 2 minutes because
we didn't get
chaotic.
As much as was predicted for New York City and Albany, but it was still a
decent
pretty
little
big,
snowstorm.
It was a pretty good sized snowstorm. So anyway, all right. So here we go.
Here we go.
Let's for get really into time. It. I you know what I forgot to get up.
Rumble
the Rumble report.
Here, go ahead. Look at your nose. All right. Talk. I'll get the Rumble up.
All right. So.
First thing we're going to run down, we've got about 20 minutes. We'll run down the Royal Rumble pay-per-view. There's not much to talk about. For Monday Night Raw.
Oh, I thought you were talking about the Rumble. There's not much to talk about.
No, the Rumble. I want to talk about the Rumble match itself. So the rest of the show is going to be pro wrestling in our numero dos. We're going to be taking your rapid fire questions. We're going to run down all this news and rumors. If we have time for live phone calls, we'll be taking those as well. We'll go out the live phone number here in just a little bit when we come back in our numero dos. Let me get the plugs out of the way. The official home, the official website of WZR TV Tuesdays, WZROnline.com. We're on Facebook, Twitter, and YouTube as well. Go to Facebook.com/WZRArmy, YouTube.com/WZRArchive. We're on Twitter as well. All you got to do is go to WZROnline.com, top navigation bar, got a drop-down menu, social media tab. It's right there. It's right up top.
Can't miss it.
All you got to do is hit that. It's got a links to Facebook, yes. Twitter, and YouTube, WZROnline.com, the official home of WZR TV Tuesdays. Our live chat room. Our archives are
back. I was going to say, that's before the chat. Yeah, it's part of the social media thing, the interaction. YouTube.com/user/WZR archive. You get all the archives over there.
YouTube.com/WZR archive.
There's times it works and times it doesn't for me.
It works, man.
All right, well, YouTube.com/WZR archives. We started archiving again last week. We'll have archive this week and every week from now on again. No more problems with the archives. Big shout out to Daniel Humphreys for running the YouTube channel, doing a great job.
Big ups, man. Big ups.
The archives.
All right, so in the chat room, we have a lot of people.
I don't even know where it is.
There are a lot of people listening tonight. Traffic is high on the websites. A lot of people in our chat room tonight. How do they get there?
There's no traffic ban when you're heading to the chat room. That's for goddamn sure. You see what I did there?
Traffic ban, travel ban.
Yeah, same thing.
I get it.
Same thing.
I like that.
We won't ban
traffic
you.
And travel.
We won't
I
ban,
like that.
We won't ban you traveling to the chat room. You can travel right on over. Well, how can they travel to the chat room? Where do they go? What do
how
they
can
do?
They travel? Well, if there's not a ban in place.
No ban.
There's not tonight.
Well, if you say too many stupid things, you get banned, but yeah.
Right. Oh, look at you. You're still
twice.
Going.
That's twice, folks.
That's, son of a, this fucking guy right here. WZROnline.com/chat. WZROnline.com/chat. Lots and lots of people in there, as always, tonight. Get in there, man. WZROnline.com/chat. All you gotta do is WZROnline and then / or forward slash.
You gotta do a .com.
Forward. Is that a forward or a back?
We would always call it / for years, and then we learned.
Why does everyone say /
Forward slash.
But everybody says /.
I know. We used to do it when we were young. Everybody would say, yeah, /, blah, 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 blah. No, it's /.
Everybody still does that.
I know.
Even it's always something /.
But /sounds cleaner. It's more people are familiar with the phrase /.
It's forward. It goes
/. Is like one word. /. /. Is two words. It's uglier. It's dirtier. It's but it's the truth. It's /.
Yeah, it's like WZROnline.com/.
Yeah,
it doesn't roll off the tongue.
It's not smooth. Yeah.
All right. So anyways, so WZROnline.com/.
That's
slash.
Why we switched it to /. The plug used to be
/.
Whatever our chat was back in the day, it was .com/chat.
Right.
Remember, we used to set up a meta forward tag.
Meta tag, right.
Yeah, it was
right.
/chat, and the index.html would automatically forward to whatever our cheap little chat room was at the time.
Right.
And our plug was, I think it was the site that should not be named anymore, .com/chat.
Yes.
And we would do .com/chat. And then somebody emailed me once and said, no, you know, it's a /, not a /.
All right. No doubt. All right, so here we go. WWE Royal
Switched
Rumble.
Just slash. We didn't like saying /.
Yeah. Right. Way to go.
That's how that came
about. Way to go. Anyways, so the Royal Rumble. Let me ask you something.
Ask me a lot of things.
I thought that the Royal Rumble was a pretty fucking good show. Except for the main thing. The Royal Rumble match.
Off the top of my head, the Usos match was awesome, and the Triple Threat match was awesome. Was the rest of the show awesome?
There was a Divas match in there, which was kind of hit or miss. But I thought the WWE title match.
Oh, the six-man on the pre-show was good, too.
Yeah, that was pretty
good,
too.
That was a good match.
I thought it was a... What you guys think in the chat? Let us know, man. I thought it was a good
front slash. We could do that instead of /. Front slash.
WZRonline.com.
Slash.
But anyway, I thought it was a good show, except for the Royal Rumble match.
Yeah.
That was the only thing that I
really...
Even
the first half of the Rumble was pretty dope.
Yeah.
Bubba Ray Dudley, and you had DDP in there. And
right. And Bubba Ray came out of what, number three?
Yeah.
Number
it started three. Off with R-Truth and Miz because they needed a black guy, let's just come out and say it, to replace D-Von Dudley.
You know what, here. You know what, we'll get through it, because I want to talk, that's what I want to talk about the most here, is the match itself.
All right.
But we had a New Day against Tyson Kidd, Cesaro, and Adam Rose.
It actually changed,
right?
It was supposed to be a six-man elimination match, and it became a tag team match.
Right.
Rose wasn't in it, and Xavier Woods wasn't in it. Xavier Woods is injured, so he couldn't compete.
Right.
But anyways, it was a good match, and in the end, Tyson Kidd and Cesaro. Cesaro was way over in Philly, too, by the
he
way.
He was way over. They loved him, man.
And, they
loved
him. Some cool spots, and in the end, they got the win.
They opened the pay-per-view with the Ascension against the New Age Outlaws. We saw what happened on Raw the previous week. The Ascension's been calling out legends, saying that they're better than them. This, that, and the other thing. Finally, this burial of the Ascension has continued week after week on Raw, where, you know, they get beat down, or they're beating up jobbers.
Yeah, they might
get
beat down once. Now it's by like eight guys. So that
I get.
You know,
I'm
telling you, you see it as a burial. I see it as a burial. I'm not arguing with you, but WWE thinks this is a way to get them over as heels. This is a way to get them heat.
I know.
I disagree.
Exactly
just the same way you disagree.
But I know
the burial doesn't continue. It never started, as far as they're concerned. But I know what you're saying.
I know exactly what you're saying.
So technically, their push continues, but yeah, this was the first time it wasn't a retarded way to push them.
That's exactly it. You know what I mean? It's all right, they've been getting buried on the microphone by legends. You know, last week on Raw, the NWO was out there.
That was the only time they were buried by legends. Every other week, it's been them burying legends.
Right,
Which kind of makes them look bad, because the announcers didn't say, oh, you guys aren't even close to as good as Legion of Doom. How is that?
Who are you guys?
Yeah,
you know
guys
what I mean?
Haven't beat anybody. You're beating two nobodies right now, so it makes their wins
but
unimportant.
They defeated the New Age Outlaws. The crowd was chanting, "You still got it," at both of them, Billy Gunn and Road Dogg. But Billy Gunn, the guy,
he's a
hair, by the way.
Yeah.
But the guy doesn't age.
We talked
Billy
about that
Gunn does
too.
Not age.
The Billy and Chuck look when they did the gay wedding.
Yeah.
He had the short blonde hair then too.
But he doesn't age.
No. As far as his athletic ability, the guy can still fucking do everything he used to do, and it looks the same. And he's got to be, what, 48, 47, 46?
Yeah.
Mid to high 40s, I would
say. He's got to be close to 50, I think.
Dude, when I was a kid smoking guns, Bart and Billy Gunn, I remember that.
Yeah.
Was, you know, he had the long hair and the mustache and shit.
But the Ascension won this with, I think they call it the Fall of Man.
Something like that.
I think that's their finishing move or something like that. Triple H and Stephanie McMahon are backstage to talk about having a problem with Sting.
Heyman said, you guys had a problem with this guy. Brock Lesnar.
You got problems with everybody. If you need a problem solver.
Yeah, Brock Lesnar can solve it.
Can solve it. All right, we had the Usos against Miz and Mizdow. How over is Damian Sandow?
Mizdow, he's way over.
Mizdow. Damian Sandow.
I don't think Sandow would be that over. It's Mizdow that's over.
It's Mizdow.
Yeah, if he goes back to just being Damian Sandow, I don't know how over that guy is, which therein lies the problem.
You think they do that match at WrestleMania, Miz and Sandow? Is that where the split?
I don't
happens?
Watch SmackDown, but I was listening to a radio show, and they said they've been hyping up like the premiere of the Miz's movie,
right?
Like some movie they're going to do as an angle, not a real movie, like an angle movie.
Oh, really? All right.
And supposedly that's when the split happens, or something like that. But anyways,
well, Sandow's finally going to have enough and say, you know what? I'm tired of this.
They teased that in
the crowd. The crowd cheers me, and they boo you. I'm sick
they
of it.
They started because he hasn't even shown any signs of, like, I'm getting sick of this bullshit.
Right.
Until the Rumble match where he came out, and Miz came out behind him, like, no, I'm going in for a second time. I'm taking your spot. And then Miz got hit or something and went down, and then Mizdow kind of looked and debated for a second, like, did I disobey my boss?
You've got the Fastlane pay-per-view too, dude. You know what I mean? So you could really tease the split there, or the split will happen
build
there.
A match up to Mania.
And then the match at Mania.
I would assume,
exactly.
Mizdow Mania makes sense.
You would think so.
I would hope so.
Yeah, I would too.
Because like you said, we've been saying for weeks, you way too long, and people aren't even going to be cheering the Mizdow thing anymore.
Right,
the game
right,
the Mizdow.
Right. We had the Bella Twins against Paige and Natalya.
This was good for what it was.
It was pretty much squash.
Bella squashed them.
Bella squashed squashed them. Paige and Natalya. So it was the Divas match, but it was in between. Or no, you know what? It wasn't in between anybody. It came early on in the show. We had Roman Reigns was backstage once again at the Royal Rumble, cutting these corny promos.
This was you're just reading the first line. This was where they did everybody's interview. I'm going to win the Royal Rumble because. I'm going to win the Royal Rumble because they do that every year since I've been a small kid. It just doesn't seem as cool when you, like, the guys are, like, seem like jobbers. When you're a kid, even jobbers seem like larger than life heroes.
But, yeah. We had Brock Lesnar, John Cena, and Seth Rollins. We can admit that this was match of the show.
Match of the year.
I mean, we're only in January. I mean,
It'll hold up. I think it'll hold up.
Dude, this was
It was good.
Awesome.
And I know because I saw it twice already. I watched it again last night on Raw.
Crowd had, you know, this is awesome chance in the latter stages of
the match. It was even a unique positive chant. What the fuck? Wasn't the marking out chant, but it was something to that effect, which had me laughing. But yeah, there was a lot of chants, a lot of pops.
Philly crowd was great on Sunday night. They really were, until Daniel Bryan got eliminated from
the Rumble. Well, even then, they're great. They're just great at shitting on something, you know?
Right, right. So, Lesnar winds up retaining here. And we were talking about going in.
Yeah.
Does Rollins cash in? Does John Cena win the title? Is Brock Lesnar leaving WWE? They kept it very, very basic.
It's worth noting, because we haven't even mentioned it yet. Going into Royal Rumble, the pay-per-view, all day Sunday, WWE, we had mentioned that The Rock was in Philly. All day Sunday, WWE decided we're not going to do a subtle tease.
Right.
The top story of their website, The Rock, this and that, and here's what's worth mentioning. Their article that they wrote on WWE.com, which was all over their Twitter, all over their... It was their top story.
They were linking it everywhere, man.
The two things they mentioned in that article. A, is he going to be in the Royal Rumble as a surprise?
Right.
Or, not, you know, here's possibilities. It was like, either this or this is pretty much what's going to happen, is how you would read it as a fan.
Right.
Either he's in the Royal Rumble as a surprise, or he's got unfinished business with Brock Lesnar.
Exactly.
Tying that into now. So when Brock Lesnar won, there was no cash-in. I am still of the opinion that
Rock's coming out here.
Rock says, he's going to be a surprise in the Rumble. He's going to win.
Yeah.
And the WrestleMania is The Rock versus Brock Lesnar.
Well,
which has been rumored forever.
They got to number 29, and I said, all right, the 30th guy is going to be Rock. It's got to be Rock to come out.
It wasn't. Of course,
it wasn't. It was. No. I forget who the 30th
guy
was.
A couple key spots in the Lesnar match, they did the...
It was Ziggler. Ziggler was number 30.
Yeah, I think they did make sure it was somebody that people would cheer. But it was Ziggler. Brock Lesnar got AA'd three times in a row, immediately into a curb stomp and a pin, but he kicked out. He was put on the
table. They did the power slams early, too, right?
The German suplex. Yeah, he was doing that throughout the whole match.
Right.
There was a spot where they put Lesnar on a table.
Right.
Rollins did a big elbow through the table. It was awesome. And then from there, Lesnar would just sell on the floor for the rest of the match until the finish.
Right.
He didn't move.
Right.
And they had the paramedics come down, the whole thing, the announcers. All right, so they do that.
Well, Lesnar was bloody, too, so they had the doctors come out and...
Yeah, yeah.
And
they said he broke his rib, was how they explained it.
Right,
why would you be laying there that long for a broken rib?
Right.
They should have said, oh, he's unconscious or something.
Yeah.
You know, that's why he hasn't moved for fucking 7 minutes, but... it looks like kind of like a pussy, a rib.
So, Lesnar came in and hit the
Rollins
debris.
Did a big fucking twisting, flippy fucking splash off the top on the scene. That was a high spot.
Right.
And then the finish saw, Lesnar came in and got rid and then did the... Did the pin.
And 1, 2, 3, that was it. I mean, there was no interference.
He looked
anything
like a beast
that.
In the process. They really made him look strong.
An awesome, awesome match.
Amazing match.
Match of the show, match of the year so far, although we're only 3 weeks in.
Yeah.
But to the year.
Although, actually, if you're going to count some of those New Japan Pro Wrestling Wrestle Kingdom 9 matches,
that's true.
It's hard
that's
to compete with those.
Then we get to the 30-man over-the-top Battle Royal. All right? So the first guy out was nobody big. It was The Miz was out first.
And
R-Truth was out second. We know why they did that, as you had Miz and R-Truth number one and number two. So you're not off already to a hot start. Number three, Bully Ray comes out as a surprise.
Bubba Ray Dudley
in WWE.
The fucking tie dye
came out with the old gimmick, the Dudley Boys
gimmick,
which was
a fucking shame, by the way. I mean, you had to do it.
Yeah,
but it seems like a step down. Here's one half of this fucking tag team from 10 years ago. You know, all right. As opposed to here's like the best heel in the business for the last 3 years.
So you know that they're gonna do the D-Von get the tables, yeah. Or you're gonna do the 3D is what they call it.
You're assuming
right?
D-Von's coming out number four.
What do they
four.
Call it? When it's the 3D in TNA for Team 3D, the Dudley
Death Drop. It's the 3D.
Dudley Death Drop.
Yeah, all they right. became Team 3D so, because their finisher was called the 3D.
So you know that they're gonna do that spot in the Rumble. And you know, all right, D-Von's not gonna be there. We found that out later.
Yeah.
We didn't know
we
that.
We probably assumed
right?
I did. I was like, all right, number four is obviously D-Von or five or six.
I'm thinking to myself, all right, you're gonna do this spot, and if you get D-Von out there, of course you're gonna do this spot. Because they didn't have D-Von there. And this is going to sound racist.
No, it's not
going it?
To sound racist. It's it was sound, racist.
But you got another black man.
Could anybody stand there and
you
could have pushed him.
Anybody.
Axel, get the tables. It's
anybody.
Not to be a black guy. It had no
but
purpose.
Instead, and this is the reason that R-Truth came out number two, because you needed a black man in there to do that spot.
Correct.
So, Bubba goes... Our truth?
Yeah. No, it's a truth.
Truth? Yeah. Something like that. And they do it, but it just,
they
it's
did
like,
the
our truth.
They did the get the tables, and
so,
Truth helped do the 3D with
so
it.
So our truth, another black man, another African-American, you have him out there to replace D-Von. And I just, maybe I'm overreacting
no,
here.
No, you're not.
But
yes.
It
Where's
was another black
pen
man.
At? Give me this pen.
It was another black man that was out there.
Are they under production meeting? All right.
To do that
Our
spot.
Roster. Who's the black guys? R-Truth, Big E. Who's the most athletic black guy who could do a good job in the room?
It's Spike Dudley. Somebody in the
Why
chat.
Why did it have
who
to be a black
that?
Guy? It didn't have to be a black guy.
It's Spike Dudley. Get anybody.
To the guy
a
with
contract
the, to
with
the guy with the pen, he was nothing more than a black body. That's who R-Truth was. He was
a black
guy,
body.
He was exactly. a guy with black skin. That's all he was.
That's a baby face. He needed a baby face. It couldn't have been Mark Henry. It couldn't have been...
Kofi Kingston.
Kofi.
Or
well,
they're kind of baby face heels.
Kofi's,
you never really
I guess,
know.
Is a,
yeah.
is a heel. Could have been Kofi. Speaking of Kofi, every year, Kofi does a Royal Rumble spot.
Yep.
Every year, he does something crazy.
I was bringing that up, though, but you reminded me he did kind of do one.
Kind of did one,
I
but
didn't
this
think it was
year
spot.
They bring out Adam Rose's rosebuds, right?
Yeah.
Kofi gets thrown over the top rope, and the rosebuds catch him.
Yeah,
and they put him
like,
back
like
in.
Crowd surfing.
They put him back in.
Yeah,
so
yeah,
it's
yeah.
like all right, year after year. I understand. There's only so much you can.
You
do.
Run out of ideas after
you
a while.
You run out of
and
ideas.
He's done what? The handstand on the floor, the pogo stick with the chair, the jump
right.
into the balcony, the landing. Oh, my feet only hit the stairs.
Right.
So he's done like pretty much everything you can do, you know.
So that was the big Kofi Kingston spot this year. It was the rosebuds. They caught him. He didn't hit the ground. They throw him back in. Then we get to Daniel Bryan.
He also did like a Matrix kick too, like a fucking ninja.
That was good. He was good.
But that wasn't a
so. Then we get to Daniel Bryan. So Daniel Bryan comes out what 8, 9, 10 somewhere around there.
Daniel Bryan.
He was 8, 9, 10.
Yeah.
Pretty
I mean, I can get
out,
the numbers
right?
up right now, but we don't need
And he's in there for a while, and of course...
God, he was only in there for like 8
well,
minutes.
Well, they had this whole Twitter campaign that, you know, no Roman Reigns in the Royal Rumble. We don't want him to win, or we'll riot if Roman Reigns wins.
How funny a year so before, too, by the way, because last year, when the crowd was shitting all over the Rumble...
Everybody loved Reigns. They wanted Reigns.
When last year, when everybody was shitting on the Royal Rumble because Daniel Bryan wasn't in it, the only guy that they would cheer, because they knew Batista had come back... just to win the Rumble and main event WrestleMania. The only guy that we were willing to cheer
Reigns.
Was Roman Reigns.
Was Reigns.
And this year, he's the only guy that they, no matter what, we're going to boo.
And you know why?
Because they knew he was
going to
win.
Because they ruined Reigns. They ruined
well, that
him
too,
with the
they
corny
knew.
Jokes, with the promos, with everything.
Also, the Philly fans are smart. They knew one of two people was winning that match.
Right.
Daniel Bryan or Roman Reigns. And if it wasn't Bryan, they were going to resent Reigns because he was the guy chosen instead of Daniel Bryan.
You said it to me the other day. You said... If Daniel Bryan wasn't going to win the Royal Rumble,
why bring him back?
There were only two other guys.
Yeah.
There were only two other guys that the Philly crowd would have been happy with winning the Rumble.
Yeah.
And those two guys
Ziggler
are
Ambrose.
Ziggler and Ambrose.
Yeah.
Ziggler and Ambrose. And they got them both. They took them both out.
The only guys that they were really cheering.
So
from when Bryan got eliminated to the end of the match, the only guys they really cheered. The Rock had a big pop coming out, but then they started booing when they realized he was helping Reigns. There was Ziggler they would cheer.
Yep.
There was Ambrose they would cheer, and they cheered the Mizdow thing when he was teasing coming in, because that was after Bryan. Those were the only guys that they were even willing to cheer, really. DDP, I think, was after Daniel Bryan. He got some cheers.
DDP came out as a surprise. Yeah. I mean,
he's
we
looked great
that
for his old ass. That motherfucker's like 58 years old. He's doing diamond cutters.
Here's the deal. So, Daniel Bryan, they eliminate him.
50 years old, I'm sorry.
I think it was like right before the 16th or 17th guy came out.
10, the chat says.
All right. So, it was maybe the 16th or 17th guy was about to come out, and that was about the time that Daniel Bryan got eliminated, when the 16th or 17th guy was coming out. So, my thoughts, and I think this was WWE's thoughts, is, all right, we're going to get Daniel Bryan out of here early. The crowd's going to be pissed off, but there's still another 13, 14 guys that have to come out. So, by the time this thing is over, the crowd will be calmed down. Well, they'll be over Daniel Bryan. We got him out. We got him out early.
More than that.
I'm going to get there with Rock and everything else. But
if they're not, they're right.
But so anyways, Daniel Bryan, we eliminate him fairly early on in the match. We get him out of there. The crowd's going to boo the next couple guys that come out, and they'll get it out of their systems. That's exactly what happened. But that's what I'm saying.
Okay.
That's what I'm saying.
Exactly what happened.
So they eliminate Daniel Bryan, and the crowd goes nuts, right? They are pissed. Next guy comes out, booze. Next guy comes out, booze. Next guy comes out, booze. And you're thinking, all right, 3-4 guys have come out. They're going to get over the Daniel Bryan thing.
You're thinking that?
It didn't happen.
I wasn't thinking that.
It didn't happen.
Oh.
The crowd kept booing.
Bro.
And booing. And booing. And booing until the end of the fucking match, right? So then you've got Dolph Ziggler comes out, you've got Ambrose who comes out, the crowd pops for them, and they're thinking, all right, we're over Daniel Bryan for now.
It's not, we're over.
But
those pops meant like, all right, well, as long as this guy wins, we'll be okay.
As long as Ziggler's in there and Ziggler wins it, we'll be okay.
Yeah, we'll accept Ziggler.
All right, Ambrose is in here now.
We'll accept Ambrose.
If Ambrose wins,
we'll take Ambrose.
We'll take, as a backup.
As a consolation.
Right, as a consolation prize, we'll take it, right? So Daniel Bryan's gone. Ziggler's in there. They're still booing about Bryan. And then Ziggler gets eliminated. And the crowd fucking right back to, all right, there's no Daniel Bryan, there's no Ziggler, right? Then Ambrose. Ambrose is in there. Ambrose gets eliminated. The crowd went fucking ballistic.
They kept Ambrose in the final four because it was
Ambrose was in the final
four. Final
five because
Rusev was hiding outside the ring. Final four, technically, was Big Show Kane on one side, Reigns Ambrose on the other.
Right.
Ambrose was the first of those four.
You had two big guys.
They realized it was one of these three fuckers, and we don't want any of these guys.
You had two big guys in Kane and
Big Show.
And Big Show, the Authority, against the Shield, right?
Yep.
The Authority and the Shield come down to the final four, right? And Roman Reigns, so at that point, all right, it's the Shield, you still got Ambrose in there. Once Ambrose got eliminated, everybody said, all right, now it's down to Roman Reigns, the Big Show, or Kane.
And Rusev.
Right? And Rusev. So everybody is like, all right, Reigns is going to win. The crowd booed all of them out of the arena, right?
Well, Roman they kind of chanted, "We want Rusev" at one point, so they were even.
They chanted, "We want Rusev."
They
might even
be satisfied with him. Like,
you're
anybody
right.
But Reigns will be all right with.
So WWE's thoughts is, all right, going into the Rumble, this is not during, but going into the Rumble, Daniel Bryan, we got him out early.
Please let me interrupt you. I keep wanting to make this point. You won't let me get in. If they knew that, and you're agreeing with me that they knew Daniel Bryan was going to get booed, or they were going to boo when Daniel Bryan got eliminated. They knew this.
They knew it.
How long ago did Daniel Bryan make his return? After being gone for months.
Less than a month ago?
3 weeks ago.
Yeah.
Why not hold off his return until after the Rumble so he ain't got to worry about this shit?
He ain't got to worry about it.
And the other option...
They wanted him back.
The other option, the reason they booed so vociferously was because they made him look like a jobber. He came out in the middle. He got eliminated in the middle. He didn't even make it to the end.
I know.
You know what I mean? They didn't even... If they would have saved him for the final guys, the only booing that would have happened would have lasted like 4 minutes because there wouldn't have been much left to go.
All right.
You know what I mean?
Yeah.
But they threw him out in the middle, so they had the whole second half of booing. If they would have saved him for the final four, booing wouldn't have started because they wouldn't have known if he was winning or not until the very end.
So
and
Roman
the
Reigns,
over anyway.
So
they didn't have the title match after the Rumble.
So Roman
they
Reigns
went right off the air with booing.
Roman
but
Reigns
only been 4 minutes of booze instead of 30.
Roman Reigns winds up winning this thing.
He wins.
I agree 100% with you. By the way, dude, but. Roman Reigns winds up winning this thing. Now, of course, the crowd boos the shit out of it. They wanted an Ambrose. They wanted a Ziggler. They wanted Daniel Bryan.
Yes.
It didn't happen. So Roman Reigns. So The Rock.
Yeah, The Rock.
The Rock's music it. Real life cousins.
After the 30 era he come in, so it wasn't like, oh, he's number 31.
No.
You know, there is no 31.
So after it's over,
I gotta mention celebrating the Curtis Axel thing.
You know what? We're gonna save this when we come back from the break. Right. We're gonna
the Curtis Axel thing made it almost like maybe The Rock is an entrant because Axel never technically went in the match.
And if you remember, there were photos, and we have them at WZRonline.com. Michael McGillicuddy, and at the time Curtis Axel was training with The Rock. So
yeah.
You're thinking, all right, Curtis Axel, The Rock, they've got kind of a history here.
There's where you take it way too far, but yeah,
something
okay.
like that. But anyway, so The Rock's music hit. Roman Reigns is celebrating. The Rock's music hits.
I don't have Roman Reigns' theme. God
and what is,
damn it.
What is WWE's opinion? The Rock is going to save us. He's going to save it. As soon as The Rock comes out and he puts over Roman Reigns, everything is well. Why? Because The Rock is out there.
I don't
and
have
Roman
Reigns
is
I'm
there. Play whatever.
Go ahead.
Play whatever. But The Rock is going to save it because we've got... And The Rock got a huge pop, by the way. But The Rock is going to save it, and he's going to hold the hand up of Roman Reigns. By the way, The Rock was not happy.
No, he was pissed.
The,
you can see it in his
Rumble.
Face, by the way. Yeah.
You definitely see it. And Daniel Bryan was pissed off, too, which we have in our notes here.
Yes, we do.
We're going to talk about that. So, when we come back, we're going to talk the end of the Royal Rumble, what happened when The Rock came out, Roman Reigns. You guys all saw it. But anyways, we're going to talk about it when we come back. Also, all this news and rumors
Raw.
And Monday Night Raw from last night. We're going to touch base on that. Rapid fire as well. We're going to be taking your rapid fire questions. Matty Boone, tell them how they can submit rapid fire questions.
Simply go to Facebook.com/... Ryan Clark WZR. That's Facebook.com/RyanClarkWZR. Top post, let's get your questions and comments for the hour number two rapid fire segment. When we return from the break, we'll answer them in a rapid style fashion. That's why we call it rapid fire. Facebook.com/RyanClarkWZR. We'll be back.
You are listening to WZR TV with Matt Boone.
Me.
I'm Ryan Clark.
Him.
We'll be back.
Yes.
Right after this.
Oh! David's
Oh! Alright. So, the official home of WZR TV Tuesdays, WZRonline.com. We're on Facebook, Twitter, and YouTube as well. Facebook.com/WZR Army, YouTube.com/WZR Archive. We're on Twitter as well. Go to WZRonline.com. Top navigation bar, social media tab, drop down menu. It's got all the links to Facebook, Twitter, and YouTube. WZRonline.com. The official home of WZR Tuesdays. All right.
Yeah.
Before we get into all this news and rumors, and rapid fire as well.
It's a quick pee break. How did they even wash their hands? They thought we were quick this week with the commercial.
Well, we were pretty quick this week,
like 2 or 3 minute commercial.
We were pretty quick. Yeah. We started a little bit late tonight, so...
Trying to make up for it.
Got
to
come back a little bit early from the break. But anyways, Roman Reigns winds up winning the Royal Rumble. Crowd went ballistic.
Yeah.
I mean, they had already been booing.
The thing we were getting into before the break was the Axel dynamic.
Mm-hmm.
Curtis Axel came out, I want to say number 6, I want to say.
You're right,
but
it got attacked.
Yeah, well, they were doing the Wyatt family reunion kind of thing at the time. Bray Wyatt was like throwing everybody. He was doing the Roman Reigns gimmick from last year. The Diesel gimmick, the Kane gimmick, where he's throwing everybody out.
Throwing everybody out.
Yeah, and he even got on the mic at one point and said, in case you guys in the back haven't, this is my year.
All right,
so Luke Harper comes out. They go face-to-face, and then they decide they're just going to beat everybody up together.
Mm-hmm.
And then Curtis Axel's music hits. I want to say number 6, not important. He comes out, and before he even makes it halfway down the ramp, Eric Rowan, who's not even in the Rumble, because they made all the three guys, Eric Rowan, Ryback, and Ziggler, who got fired, they made them qualify for the Rumble on SmackDown last week.
Mm-hmm.
Ryback and Ziggler did qualify. Rowan didn't. He lost, I guess.
Okay.
I didn't watch it, but that's what I read.
All right.
So Rowan's not even in the match, but he comes out anyways and attacks Curtis Axel from behind. He goes in the ring.
Mm-hmm.
We get this big Wyatt family showdown, and then it's
basically replace Curtis Axel. He says, I'm attacking you, I'm taking your spot.
I guess, yeah.
Yeah.
So Rowan gets in the ring, and him and Harper look at each other, and then they look at Wyatt, and they're like, we're going to beat Bray Wyatt's ass.
right.
And as they close in on him, Wyatt and Harper turn and beat the fuck out of Rowan.
And Axel was nowhere found.
All the while, Axel is just laid on the aisleway, the ramp, and never comes into the ring, so he never officially entered, so he was never officially eliminated.
True.
So, technically, in my brain, when number 30 was done and The Rock wasn't it, I'm like, well, maybe there's technically, and the announcers could explain it.
Curtis Axel's coming in here.
No. They could justify there's an open spot still that hasn't been filled because Axel never hit the ring.
Right.
So I'm thinking maybe The Rock is that guy. I don't know. Right. But he wasn't. He was just, so all that hype they did, which was what I was building up to before the commercial, he's either got issues with Brock still or he's entering the Rumble, blah, blah, blah. All this hype that they did with The Rock.
Nothing.
All he did was come out and help Reigns win and then he's gone again. That's it.
That was it.
We're already booking the WrestleMania main event. Brock Lesnar versus The Rock, and he's not even back.
I think in WWE's opinion, listen, they knew going in that once they eliminated Daniel Bryan, there was going to be boos. And there was, okay? I think in WWE's opinion, they didn't expect those boos to last as long as they did, because you were going to have Ziggler and Ambrose, who both came out after
they
him.
They thought that would offset it, The Rock.
They thought it would offset it, and I think when Roman Reigns won the Rumble, I think WWE knew by what was going on social media and the way that they'd been reacting to Roman Reigns here, but I think Vince McMahon is so dead set on pushing Roman Reigns and shoving him down our throats. This Roman Reigns is Vince McMahon's guy and
pet project.
And his pet project. And I feel like Vince thought, all right, let's say that they do boo Roman Reigns winning the Rumble. As long as the Rock's music hits and The Rock comes out and holds his hand up and says,
he endorses
the guy.
Yeah.
He endorses him and says,
as long as The Rock approves, you guys will cheer too because you love The Rock so much.
The Rock comes out, huge pop for The Rock. The Rock gets in the ring, he does the same thing. Roman Reigns, one other, and the crowd booed the shit out.
Yeah.
Why? Because the crowd didn't want Roman Reigns. They want Daniel Bryan. It's the same thing. Vince, everybody, nobody wanted Daniel Bryan, but the crowd was so adamant that we want Daniel Bryan. Yes, and every week. I think with Roman Reigns, it's going to be the complete opposite, where the crowd is going to start booing Reigns week after week.
Turn him heel.
And then you're going to turn him heel, and then that'll get him over. It would be something like that, but Vince McMahon is so dead
set.
Maybe
Heyman turns on Lesnar and helps Reigns.
Talked about that. You talked about
that.
With Lesnar possibly leaving WWE, who would be next for Heyman to manage? Roman Reigns, a guy that's not a very good talker right now as
it is. He's good when he's unscripted.
But do a turn.
Or bullet pointed.
If the crowd from now until WrestleMania, if they're shitting all over
that's where last
Roman
week's
Reigns
was a blessing in
disguise. Have Heyman turn on Lesnar and join Reigns.
That's where last night's Raw was a blessing in disguise, because that crowd following up from the Rumble, they would have shit all
they
over Reigns.
They would have shit all over it.
But
dude,
there was no crowd to boo him, so they could do whatever they wanted in those quiet studio interviews, and they really tried again to make Lesnar the big, bad, dastardly heel.
And then Reigns to be the baby face, and they even did the history
of his family. Oh, I'm related to Rikishi and the Usos and The Rock and this and that. So like
that may have been their saving grace last night.
As I said, blessing in disguise.
Next week,
maybe everybody's calmed down. Yes,
everybody's calmed down by next week.
Not next week. It's Thursday.
It's Thursday.
And it's in the same city that they were going to do Raw, in Hartford.
It's in Hartford.
Nobody's forgetting
about the Royal Rumble. No. People were pissed off.
And it'll be the same crowd,
because
if you bought tickets for Raw on Monday for Hartford, you're going to be in Hartford on Thursday for SmackDown.
Can I say another thing?
That bought Rumble tickets probably bought Raw tickets.
Absolutely.
A lot of them.
It's going to be the same
crowd. So you're going to have a crowd booing the shit out of them, and it's not taped, so you can't edit it. It's live.
Probably.
So you're gonna have that same dilemma to deal with, hopefully. And they've got don't they have a face to face with Lesnar and Reigns scheduled?
They do for
SmackDown.
So they
gotta be careful with that, how they book it.
And not only that, but I feel bad. I mean, if anybody's listening from Boston right now, you guys were gonna get a SmackDown television taping. Now you're getting a house show
in June.
June 27th.
Yeah.
It's like, man, Boston got screwed. If anybody got screwed,
get your
Boston got hit with 3 feet of snow. Now they don't have a TV taping. They've got a house show in June. They've got to wait 3 months. It's a house show. It's not a TV taping. They got 3 feet of snow on the ground. Poor people in Boston, man.
Can I give you a scenario?
Poor Boston.
People will always say, well, you can get a refund.
Yeah.
Can I tell you something me and my stepdad did once? I think I was 11 or 12 years old.
All right.
There was a Nitro in Baltimore, Maryland. My godfather, Tommy.
Okay.
Won Nitro tickets off a radio contest.
All right.
And it was the night after Starrcade where Sting beat Hogan, finally ending, you know, and became a champion.
Okay.
The next night, I'm going to Nitro.
You're going to Nitro.
We didn't live close enough to Baltimore at the time. Mm-hmm. We were living in Westminster, which was a good hour and a half, 2 hours away. So what?
Don't tell me you got a refund off radio show tickets. Oh, no. Okay. All right.
We went to a hotel because we wanted to be there so bad at the show. We went to Baltimore the night before.
Yeah.
Got a hotel.
Yeah.
Went to the show and then went home the next night. So what about people who come, especially after the Royal Rumble? You got a lot of out-of-towners for an event. That's the second biggest show of the year.
Absolutely.
So, oh, we'll give you a refund. Can you refund my hotel money, my travel money, my, you know what I mean? Like, those people are, like you said, to your point, those people are fucked. Anybody that doesn't live in Boston, anybody outside of Boston that's traveling to Boston for the SmackDown
pay-per-view. It's the second biggest pay-per-view of the year.
Pay-per-view of the year.
Like,
there's a lot of people coming in from out of town, so it's not everybody, oh, they're all from Boston, they get their refunds, they go home, no big deal. There's a lot of people that waste a lot of fucking money, and they got nothing for it.
Let me tell you guys another quick story. I came in on Monday, and Boone had just woken up on Monday morning, and I came in, and I said, Boone, I think that I think there's a possibility that Raw may be canceled tonight. And you immediately said, no way Raw's canceled.
I know you like weather, but would you stop with this shit?
You're probably right. They would never cancel Raw.
Yes.
They can't cancel Raw or postpone Raw.
And
you
said, dude, there's a travel ban.
But then,
at 3 p.m.
the governor came out, the governor of Connecticut, Malloy, came out about an hour later and said that after 9 p.m. tonight, there is a travel ban where anybody...
How long is this speech? Because I want to throw in a politician thing.
Go ahead.
Malloy, Sheldon Silver...
Yeah.
From New York, the
assembly
speaker.
I know.
He was the main guy opposing MMA being legalized
and
in New York.
He is in deep trouble right now.
We don't need to give him the whole story, but he got caught with, what was he doing? He was
money laundering.
Yeah, man. Like fucking bullshit.
He's basically using his power in New York State to gain
money.
Millions
of
dollars. He was the main opponent
Correct.
UFC.
So maybe UFC, MMA, legalization in New York. Maybe MMA can get legalized now.
They are voting tonight whether is out of office or not out of office.
Oh, he's got to be out of office, right?
I guess everybody at first came out and said, we want him out of office. Today,
he'd be arrested.
They held meetings all day today, and there are some people that say, okay, this is being overblown. We want to wait for the full story.
Oh, my God.
We want to wait for the full story. That's politics for you, man.
Such a dirty bullshit game.
I wouldn't be surprised if Silver's paying him off.
You never know.
Saying, hey, keep me
in. And a lot of people
say, I'll take care of you. I'll take care of you.
A lot of people say, because he was the main opposer, like you said, to the
New York politics are so corrupt.
Any politics is corrupt. But like you said, a lot of people thought he was the main opponent for UFC and MMA in New York. But really, it's the Culinary Union in Las Vegas.
Yeah.
Because they don't want to lose events in Vegas to New York,
right.
So like that's Dana White always said, it's not. There's this one politician in New York. It's a slimy, dirty scumbag.
Yeah,
that's Sheldon Silver.
It's Cuomo too, by the way.
Governor Cuomo's a scumbag.
He's a scumbag and a
half. Okay,
he's
enough.
His father his father was a good guy passed away. But Andrew Cuomo.
Remember last week? I didn't know that the Secretary of
State. I wouldn't be surprised if Andrew Cuomo is eventually arrested for something. I don't know what.
Jesus.
But Andrew Cuomo is.
We don't
a
like Cuomo in this house. I don't even
he
know.
Came out with a state of the state the other day. He came out with a state of the state. He says, I'm going to spend $19 million here. I'm going to spend $400 million here. I'm going to spend $45 million here. I'm going to spend $20 million here.
Whoa, calm down.
I'm
going to
spend $60 million here.
Whoa.
And there were no cuts at all. No cuts at all. I'm going to spend.
What have you got, a haircut?
Spend.
That's a cut.
Okay?
Yes.
He's going to spend.
Cut his grass.
And
in the meantime,
New York State has the highest taxes in the United States. We've got the highest tax. We have a sugar tax on soda. on soda. You go out and you buy a Pepsi or a Coca-Cola. He put a sugar tax.
Slurpee.
He put a sugar tax on soda.
What was that? The big gulp. You can't get the big gulp.
You got
anymore.
On all sodas, whether it be a 2 liter, a 1 liter. He's got a soda tax on that. He wanted to ban big gulps. Okay, well that was too much soda in one sitting.
Too much caffeine.
In one sitting. I want to ban that. But if you go to the store right now and you buy a 1 liter, 2 liter,
that's okay.
Bottle of soda, but it's taxed. He put a tax on it. He put a sugar tax.
So it's okay as long as you make me money.
We've got the highest gas prices in the entire country.
Man, that was Bloomberg.
In the entire country. That was Bloomberg. Okay. Right. Cuomo Cuomo approved it. Cuomo was the guy that approved it. All these bills, all these laws have to go through Cuomo. And Cuomo approved it. He was going to sign off on it. The legislators and everybody else would have to vote on it. But Cuomo was going to sign off on it. He agreed with it. He signed off on the sugar tax, okay?
He says, none of this is true.
What are you talking about? None of it's true.
Rogow, he's from New York. He would know, right?
What's not true? Is there not a sugar tax on soda in New York State? Do we not have the highest gas prices in New York State?
Can we turn the phones on?
In the United States? Yes, absolutely.
Right. Call us up, Rogow.
You got to be kidding me. There's a sugar tax on soda in New York State. We've got
New
the
York
highest.
State. He's saying not in New York City, so maybe you're right, and he's just talking about cities.
There's a sugar tax on all soda in New York State, okay? They didn't wind up banning the big ulps. I agree with that.
Yeah.
But
that.
There was the Mayor Bloomberg wanted to issue a ban on big ulps. No, it didn't happen.
Okay.
But and we've got the highest gas
prices.
I
didn't take your word on all this, because I don't know shit about
we've got some of the highest gas prices in the United States. New York, some of the highest gas prices. We've got a sugar tax on soda, right? We've got all these taxes. We've got some
Come
of
on,
the highest...
Right, it's too late. Go ahead.
We've got some of the highest, as far as property owners are concerned, right? Some of the highest taxes. Some of the highest school taxes.
Property taxes?
They've got Common Core in New York State. Common Core, which everybody... disagree.
I really know your shit, man. I don't know none of what you're
Common Core in New York State, poor Haley out there, can barely do her homework
the
every night.
Common Core
because
mean?
It's so fucking hard, dude. It's basically like, remember the Regents exams that you would have to take?
No.
New York has,
New
York has Regents exams. Now they've upgraded that to something called Common Core, which is much more difficult.
Come on,
basically,
Rygal, what are you doing?
It's basically like taking college courses.
Yeah.
Where you've got a kid that's in fifth grade taking high school math. You've got a kid that's in high school taking college math.
Why?
It's ridiculous. Everybody's against it. But the Board of Education presented this bill, and Cuomo signed off on it. Cuomo signs off on any bill. If a bill goes through the legislator, okay, and it passes, Cuomo is the guy that has to sign off on all this. It's like the president.
There you go.
It's like the president. If a bill passes, right? Let's say a bill passes. President Obama has to sign off on that.
Okay.
Okay?
Turn your speakers down, right?
It's the same thing with Cuomo in New York. Am I wrong, Rygal?
It depends on what it is. If it only affects the city, then the mayor is in charge of that. If it's going to affect the whole state, then it goes to Cuomo. There are two different budgets. There's the state and there's the city budget. There's different taxes. There's different tax brackets. There's different things you're going to pay upstate that we don't pay down here and vice versa. As far as a sugar tax, we don't get charged anything extra for a 2 liter of soda. We get a 5 cent bottle deposit and city tax, which is the 18.
How about that, Clark?
No. A 2 liter bottle of soda you used to buy for say, you know, 99 cents or $1.09. It's now $1.19 throughout all of New York State.
Just
so
raise the price on the
there
soda?
Is a tax. I know you have to pay the deposit. Obviously, the 5 cent bottle. I mean, that's for a bottle
but
deposit.
The tax cannot be added as part of the overall price. It has to be added as a taxed item after the fact.
Yeah, Clark.
My degree is in accounting. It's on something I know. It's separate. You have the price of the item, and if there's an additional tax, it gets taxed after the price.
Okay,
it doesn't
but
get included into
can
the
you,
price
can,
of the item.
Can you not tell me that New York State has some of the highest gas prices in the entire United
Nobody's
States.
Nobody's arguing
correct?
That.
We've got some of the highest. I know there's a shit.
Cigarette prices are fucking
insane. Do we not have Common Core up here in New York State?
Common Core is
right?
ridiculous. Common Core is absolutely. You can't teach it. Like, unless
right.
you know it, you can't help your kids with it. They reinvented math.
Do we not have some of the highest property taxes and school taxes in the entire United States, in New York?
Property taxes? We're up in the top 10, yeah.
Top 10? Top 10 in school taxes?
School taxes? I don't know.
Dude, and a lot of this is due to Cuomo. Cuomo's been in office for what, six years now? 8 years? Cuomo's been in office for, hold on, I don't know why, but the stream keeps falling behind, I don't know. But we've got some of the highest taxes, dude, and Cuomo's been in office and has signed off on this stuff over and over. And then, if you watched his State of the State the other day, on Tuesday, bro, he was spending, and then it was, yo, are there any cuts? There were no cuts, dude. It was all spending. So what do you think's gonna happen if he's spending all
of
this money?
A lot of what they wanted to cut was like education. They wanted to cut healthcare for veterans. It was a lot of stuff that you can't afford to have cut.
But you're outspending. Okay, if you were to compare how much you're gonna spend versus the amount of cuts that you're planning on doing, you are outspending so much more, which is only going to create taxes in New York State for everything. Whether it comes, I don't know where it would come from, but taxes are going
to
go up, dude. The
well,
only thing that he's
Congress
got going
has to approve that. Still, I mean, just like the president has to be approved
absolutely.
By Congress in the House,
absolutely.
The governor's budget has to be approved.
Has to be approved,
and
He said at the State of the State that they've already passed the budget, and it's 5 days early.
Oh, so, and they passed it early, and then not only did he agree to it, but it was voted in by the representatives of New York State.
I believe.
As well. It's not him solely acting alone. No single person has that much power in the United States.
No, absolutely
Everyone's
not.
Checked by somebody else.
Right. It's all got to be approved by everybody up here in Albany. Everything's got to be approved. But, I mean, they passed the budget 5 days early, which means everybody signed off on it. And he's the final one to sign off on it. And if it's his budget and he agrees to sign off on it and he's talking about passing it 5 days early, then we're good to go, and that's only going to create taxes to rise. I'm just, dude.
I thought I made a bad mistake. I thought it would be funny.
New York,
boring as
New
shit.
York,
yeah,
New York
that?
Taxes. We've got some of the highest taxes in the entire United States, bro. It's pathetic.
I know
man.
We
got a
higher rent and cigarette price. We're just expensive in New York in general.
We had David Patterson, who was a blind guy, right? A black blind guy, man.
He was the worst. He took over for Spitzer, I think.
Yeah, he took over for Pataki, right? Because Pataki had the prostitution thing. Or no,
no
was it
was
Spitzer?
Spitzer?
No, it was Spitzer that had the, it was,
Elliot
it was,
Spitzer.
Yeah, it was Elliot
With
Spitzer.
With Ashley Dupree, the call girl.
Yeah, Ashley Dupree, you're right.
Yeah, J.D.
And Anthony
Weiner
sexting his penis picture.
Yeah. We had George Pataki, who I think was all right,
Giuliani.
And then we had Elliot Spitzer, who got with the penis.
Oh, Giuliani picks. Was mayor. Yeah.
Giuliani was mayor
penis
of New York City.
Was a guy that had like the name Weiner.
Elliot's or no, that was
Andrew
that Weiner. Was another
Anthony
guy.
Anthony Weiner.
No, Elliot Spitzer. Elliot Spitzer.
He had Ashley Dupree.
Andrew. Elliot Spitzer had the Anthony. Who had Ashley Dupree? Was
that
Anthony
was
Weiner or
that
was that
Spitzer.
Elliot Spitzer?
That was Spitzer.
That was Spitzer.
That was Spitzer. Yeah.
So Spitzer had Ashley
had
Dupree,
the Wiener picks.
And Weiner had the Wiener picks on the cell phone. Yeah.
Oh.
All right, Ryan Gap, but listen,
you,
man.
New
York,
New
York
is
yo, listen.
Wiener thing.
Listen, we
you
can agree, man.
Nice.
New York sucks, bro. As far as taxes are concerned, we've got some of the highest taxes in the entire United States. Trust me, man, we do. You know it. You live in New York.
Well, yeah, but a lot of that is thanks to 9/11, and the only way to rebuild the city is by taxing its people. It's not fair, but there's... that's the only way for a city to make any money and get out of a hole, you know, is through taxes.
You know, I tell people, I tell people here in upstate, I say, you know what? When it comes time to voting, okay? When it comes time to voting for the governor and everything else, upstate doesn't matter. New York City decides the election every single year. New York City should be their own. Obviously this wouldn't happen, but New York City should be their own separate state, right? They should, because Albany votes don't matter, Buffalo votes don't matter. You can take all of upstate New York against New York City, and New York City decides the election every time. And you know what? All these politicians, they go down to New York City, and they make you guys down there, they make you guys happy. They make everybody in New York City happy, because they know that when it comes time to vote, we gotta make the New Yorkers, the New York City folks, happy. Upstate, fuck Albany, fuck Syracuse, fuck Buffalo. They don't matter, because there's so many people in New York City. Fuck all of us. Fuck all of upstate. New York City are the people. New York City are the people that we need to make happy, because when it comes time to vote, New York City is going to decide the election. Am I wrong, Rygow?
Absolutely correct.
Bam!
Rygow,
all right. We're boring the people. We get to paint this all day, bro, but we're boring the people. So.
You guys have a lovely evening to yourselves.
All right, be good, bro. Stay safe down there with all the snow. All right.
Yeah, wow, did I make a terrible mistake on suggesting
you
get
me fucking
bit.
Started, man.
I didn't realize you had one in your back pocket. I thought you were going to talk about soda tax for a minute, and he was going to make you look stupid. And then it turned into this whole fucking debate between Senator Clark and Senator Gow.
Rygow may be right on the sugar tax, but I could swear that there is a statewide sugar tax. Maybe I'm wrong.
Sorry, Winters.
But I could swear that there was a statewide sugar tax. But maybe
all
right. All right, so listen.
Yes.
Can you get through Raw, and then we can do rapid fire?
There's nothing to talk about with Raw. I mean,
there's
Raw.
No SmackDown tapings tonight. Can we run a little bit late?
I can go as late as you want. All right. Here, let's just get to, I think this is Jackie, I think. Good. Caller, you're on the air. What's on your mind?
Yeah. With the Roman Reigns situation, it reminds me a lot of the Lex Luger situation in 1993 and 1994 when they tried to force Luger, but the fans' hearts were with Brett.
No, it's very similar. I mean, but there's been a million examples, like Batista last year. They tried to force him, and they ultimately had to change their direction because the fans weren't giving up. There's been many examples, but no, if you're going to tie it directly into the Rumble, that was the turning point where they did the double elimination, him and Brett, and then ultimately they gave them both a title shot just so that they could honor the Rumble stipulation. Brett was the guy they went with, though. But I know what you're saying. And, yeah, it's pretty damn similar where Lex Luger is the chosen one. He's the next Hulk Hogan. Roman Reigns is the chosen one. He's the next John Cena. There's a lot of parallels. I completely agree.
Yeah. But the thing is, with John Cena and a lot of the other guys, they were over with the fan base before, whenever they were, you know, they were going to be pushed.
Yeah, well, I mean, Reigns was over at first, but just the last few weeks they watered it down, and it's just kind of lost momentum. And last night was like the official turning point. Go ahead.
I really think they really missed a good opportunity to gauge where he was at. After Money in the Bank last year.
Well, they make him do these cheesy jokes and everything else that people are just
scripted promos, you know, is the source of the problems. Thanks for the call, man. We got to keep moving along here. Sorry to cut you off. So
all right, listen, we're gonna mix up the news and the rumors here with the rapid fire, so we can get to all of your rapid fire questions and the news and the rumors.
I think Jackie's trying to get in.
I guess Jackie, call back if you're listening. Let's talk about Justin Gabriel.
Not a lot of details.
We don't have many
details
on this. Correct. Justin Gabriel apparently quit WWE. Basically, the day before Gabriel quit WWE, they had pulled him and the Los Matadoras from the Royal Rumble match. They were all advertised for the match. They were pulled. They pulled them off WWE.com. And then it comes out that Justin Gabriel had quit WWE. Honestly,
I can't tell.
There are no other details other than he has quit WWE. Go ahead.
You know, you're blinking the light. The light's covering the number. I can't see the fucking number. I think that's her.
Jackie, what's up?
Hey guys, what's going on?
What's up, Jackie? What's on your mind this week?
No, how how's the weather up by you guys? I heard it's snowing like crazy up there.
The weather is we didn't get hit as hard as we were supposed to get hit. We get about 6 or 7 inches here. New York City got
about
8 inches
right here, but yeah, go ahead.
New York City got about 8 or 10 inches, and Boston, the guys in Boston got about 3 feet. So it trended a little bit further east than it was supposed to go, but we still got a good amount up here, man. We got a good amount.
What's on your mind as far as wrestling?
Yeah. Well, I was pretty surprised that Rusev versus Cena got announced for Fastlane, because I was kind of wondering about that, because I was watching the Fallout after the Rumble, and I'm like, okay, what's going on with Rusev and Cena? Did Rusev say something to Lana? I mean, did Cena say something to Lana, or is this just another feud because of his association with the Authority?
Well, I mean, the storyline was, and you saw the Raw, you didn't see the Rumble part, did you?
I'll put it to you like this. We put it on the websites over the last couple of months. The plan...
We've been talking about it here. Yeah.
The plan is to do a John Cena against Rusev feud going into WrestleMania 31. Now, on Raw last night, Michael Cole mentioned that the match was going to take place at the Fastlane pay-per-view, which is the next pay-per-view coming up.
Yeah.
So, is that an angle, and they're going to postpone it until the WrestleMania 31 pay-per-view, or are they going to do a match at Fastlane, and then there'll be a screw job or something like that, and then the WrestleMania match will have
that,
a stipulation?
Something to that effect. We've been talking about it for months. Basically, the idea was to promote Rusev as an undefeated monster.
Right.
Finally, the guy that he faces at WrestleMania is going to be
Super Cena.
Super American Hero Cena. You know, they had Swagger
Cena
as like the mid-card hero that he had, you know, fucked around with for a while. And then Cena's the guy that's probably going to ultimately finally be the first guy to pin his shoulders to the mat, beat him.
Right.
Or they do the STF, make him tap out because he makes people tap out to the accolade. I don't know.
Right. Something.
But yeah, no, they're doing the Fastlane thing. That'll lead into Mania. Cena's working Rusev Mania. She's not talking about Rumble. She's talking about Rumble. And she said, why did Rusev pick a fight with Cena? The storyline explanation was he was just pissed that he got thrown out by The Rock, or The Rock helped Reigns throw him out, whatever the fuck.
Right.
So he came, while Cena was in the middle of an interview,
that's
he
right.
just came and took the mic away and started babbling, and they got face-to-face.
Basically, what Boone is saying, Jackie, is over the next couple of months, you're going to see a long, drawn-out John Cena against Rusev feud, and they started that at the Royal Rumble. On Sunday night. So you're going to see John Cena versus Rusev for the next couple of months.
Or here's what I was... Okay, here's another thing that can happen possibly at Mania. Cena and The Rock team up against Rusev and someone in the Authority.
No, they're going to do a singles program. It's going to be a long, drawn-out feud similar to... I guess I can compare it to like a Dean Ambrose versus Bray Wyatt feud.
Or even Swagger and Rusev. It'll just be the next Swagger and Cena, and he's going to be the guy that beats him.
Or for the next 2 or 3 months, I mean, you're going to have the Fastlane pay-per-view. They began the feud at the Royal Rumble on Sunday night. I'm sure you're going to see something on SmackDown tomorrow night or Thursday night. And then it's going to lead into a match at the Fastlane pay-per-view. You're going to see a rematch between those two at the WrestleMania 31 pay-per-view, but it's going to be a long, drawn-out feud between Cena and Rusev.
My prediction is the Fastlane thing either ends in a DQ, some kind of fuck-you finish, and
some
then maybe,
right.
because he's got the STF, the FU, whatever, STFU, and Rusev's got the accolade, maybe they do a submission match. There must be a winner,
something
tap out
like,
only,
right,
and
right.
then, yeah. That's how they get to
make it. There'll probably be a stipulation during the WrestleMania 31 match, and like Boone said, they're going to set that up at the Fastlane pay-per-view. But it's going to be a long, drawn-out feud, a singles feud, and not only that, but by having Rusev work with WWE's top guy in John Cena, it's only going to get him over more than he already is.
Or Rusev beats Cena. That's how they really make him.
Or it'll be Rusev beats him at Fastlane, something like that, and then at WrestleMania, John Cena gets the revenge.
And they keep it going after.
Something like that, and they even keep it going after
and
do a
grudge
match.
Yeah.
But
then,
it's gonna be that.
Extreme Rules and Money in the Bank and so on.
Very
possible.
Undertaker's
coming back.
Boone's got.
I've been hearing rumors.
Boone's got the scoop on that, man. Yeah. I'll let you...
Should we let her go so we can...
Yeah, thanks for the call, Jackie. Have a good week, all right? Be good.
All right, I'll talk to you guys next week. Stay
right.
warm.
All right, we will. Be good.
Warm. Blankets and sweaters. Yeah, no, we got a lot to get to.
I know.
No, the Undertaker thing is pretty basic. It's just, we really don't have an update. It's WWE's waiting for the update.
WWE.
They don't know yet.
Every year this happens.
They've got plans in case he does work, and they got plans in case he doesn't work, and they're just kind of pretty much waiting to find... As far as we know,
we put it up on the website. They're keeping Bray Wyatt strong as if the Undertaker does agree to do a match at WrestleMania 31.
Yeah.
It's going to be
why he beat Ambrose Bray many Wyatt. Times. That's why he beat Daniel Bryan in his first Raw match back. Everybody's like, why would Daniel Bryan lose his first match on Raw in months?
This happens
that's
every
why he
year.
At the Rumble last night or
where
Sunday night.
We come into every year. Is the Undertaker going to work that one match at WrestleMania 31? I think he is this year. I think they're keeping Bray Wyatt strong. I think they're going to go The Undertaker versus Bray Wyatt, and I think The Undertaker is eventually going to agree to put
if Taker does work, it's against Wyatt. My question I wanted to ask you, If let's just assume, let's just say right now, you're the booker,
all right,
and Taker calls you up and says, all right, I'll work. Would Wyatt be the guy you have him work against, or would you rather him do Sting or another rematch with Brock?
I think for nostalgia,
make somebody else. You know, who have him work?
For nostalgia purposes, Sting. And this is what everybody wants to see, The Undertaker versus Sting.
Correct.
And I would say, listen, it's WrestleMania, but I would also say that Bray Wyatt is a guy that is going to be in WWE for years to come.
And the characters match. They're both dark, edgy characters.
The dark, edgy character as well, and The Undertaker is the type of guy that... Despite not being there, but Sting's also 45 years old, or whatever he is, 50 years old.
No, I know, but you're talking about nostalgia.
But I'm saying, everybody wants to see Sting versus The Undertaker, but what does that do? I mean, sure, it's a draw for WrestleMania, it gets people to order, but for the future of the company, a guy like Bray Wyatt, who's going to be there for years and years to come, is it smarter to have The Undertaker work against Bray? Probably.
Definitely.
Probably.
Well, my follow-up question.
Okay.
You see how when a crowd's very clearly want something,
right?
And they don't get it. How they react?
Would they boo that match out of the building?
If Undertaker and Bray happens, would they be chanting "We want Sting"? And would they ruin it? And then when Sting match happens, would Triple H? We want Undertaker. We want Taker.
I think with WrestleMania,
are they risking the crowd shitting on both matches, not just one or the other?
I think with WrestleMania, when you've got 80,000-90,000 people in the building, you can never get a real strong chant
you
going.
You can, but it's very hard.
It's very difficult to do. So would some fans be pissed? It all depends on the build. But I think just due to the fact that the Undertaker is wrestling at WrestleMania. They do the big, long, drawn-out entrance they do every year.
Yeah.
I think it's just the Undertaker at WrestleMania, just the fact that he's at WrestleMania, it's kind of a tradition at this point.
Well, the tradition was the
crowd,
not just him wrestling.
I don't think the crowd would shit all over it. I think if the Undertaker did work against Bray,
especially if the story's strong enough,
some people in the crowd,
if they build it right, then they'll be okay.
I think they could with two dark characters like that.
Sure, they
could
do a great angle.
Then again, it's WWE, so...
Exactly. They should have been able to do a better angle with Lesnar last year. They had that footage. You want to do it? You want to go?
Yeah.
Remember at the UFC event?
Right.
They didn't even acknowledge that. It wasn't... It was just a very basic... I want
to
beat you.
I think everybody wants to see The Undertaker versus Sting, but it doesn't do much for the future of the company.
No,
sure,
I agree that it's...
It draws for WrestleMania, but for the future of the company, which you need to look out for, Bray Wyatt's the smarter move.
But also,
although, I'd like to see Undertaker.
Me too, and if you're going to do a nostalgia match, where would you do it?
At WrestleMania.
At WrestleMania. Rock Hogan does not happen at Over the Edge. It happens at WrestleMania.
Right.
Although they did a Rock Hogan rematch, I believe, at like a Backlash.
Do you think you and I could draw at WrestleMania?
No. What are you, out of your fucking mind?
Okay.
Okay.
Of course we're not going to draw WrestleMania.
Oh, okay.
No. All right. So, listen. We talked about Justin Gabriel quitting WWE. Speaking of WrestleMania, Arnold Schwarzenegger.
That's Hall of Fame, yeah. So he's joining Macho Man.
He's going to join Macho
he's
Man.
He's the celebrity guy. Do we know who's inducting him yet?
Second guy. We don't know who's going to.
You would
to
think Hogan would be the guy inducting Arnold, but Hogan's inducting
so.
Randy, so
I
be
thought
Hogan.
That Arnold.
Triple H will induct him. He's a bodybuilding freak.
Ah, you're right.
There it is.
I thought that.
And Arnold's the guy that punched Triple H to cost him the title on SmackDown that famous night.
Ah, you're
they
right.
They show clips of that.
I thought that Arnold was already in the Hall of Fame.
I didn't know.
I remember that he inducted.
He inducted.
Somebody. Not Hogan.
It was last year. He inducted Bruno.
Bruno.
Yeah,
Bruno. He inducted Martino. Bruno. So yeah, I thought it was last year, but turns out that he
inducted. You're right, I thought it too.
All right, we're going to mix this up, because I'm going to do a rapid fire as well.
All right.
So we'll just kind of do back and forth,
F5, all right. Refresh there, and get the new one.
Ooh, I wasn't going to do that, but all right, we'll do it. Oh, and there's seven more up there. All right. Oh, we didn't see him.
I didn't see
him. All right, Anthony Remy.
Anthony Remy says, from Long Island, and there is crazy amounts. I'm from Long Island, and there is a crazy amount of snow outside. I attend Ring of Honor and Royal. He said, I attended Ring of Honor and Royal Rumble Saturday and Sunday, and man, the Philly crowd was awesome. Ryan and Matt, what is your top five crowds in wrestling? As far as cities or like top five crowds to react to wrestling? Like, I would say cities, right?
Cities and wrestling, I would go Chicago number one. I would go New York or Philadelphia two and three. Chicago's number one for me.
See, I'm not going to rank them in order. Just name the five hottest.
All right, I'd go Chicago, New York, Philadelphia, Los Angeles, and I want to say Florida somewhere.
See, I'm going to go like Montreal or Toronto, maybe tied. Oh,
Canada. Philly. He said United States, didn't he?
Did he say United States? No.
No, he didn't.
Montreal and Toronto are crazy. Yeah. Philly, Chicago, Detroit, you're not putting them up there. They're crazy.
There too. I got to put Montreal up there.
You
got to
put New York in there, yeah. Baltimore is really good.
I'll go Chicago, Philly, New York, Montreal, and Los Angeles.
I feel like we're skipping an obvious one, too, like somewhere in Texas or somewhere in California.
I thought about that, though. Texas and I said L.A. for California. Okay. But all right, I would say that's my top
There's a
top
bunch
five.
Of them right there, yeah.
Lance Winter, you think WWE painted themselves in a corner with the winner gets the title shot at WrestleMania? We all know maybe two or three of the 30 guys stand a chance, and who you got on the Super Bowl. You know what? I mean, that's the thing that's fun about the Royal Rumble, as it comes down to those final couple of guys, and you're thinking to yourself, one of these guys is going to main event WrestleMania. So I like the idea that
it's always been good, but the last few years has been obvious. Obviously, Roman Reigns or Daniel Bryan was winning this year. When Bryan went out, it was obviously Roman Reigns.
Yeah.
Unless The Rock did a surprise entrance. Last year, it was obvious it was Batista, because Bryan wasn't even in it last year. It was obvious it was Batista, that's why he came back.
Right.
There's been years where it's too obvious, but generally, like you're saying, there's two or three guys,
right,
and you kind of like, ooh, which one will it be, you know?
Right, right. And
Patriots,
Super, I got to go Patriots. Yeah, I want Seattle. I can't stand the Patriots, but I want
Seattle won last year, right?
So they did. Defending champions.
That'd be crazy.
I think New England's just too good, man.
I agree.
Gronk
and they know how to play football and everything, you know?
Ryan Choptaw up next.
No reaction to play footballs. Ryan Choptaw says, Ryan.
It's been so overblown.
I know. I thought that's what you'd say. Ryan, he's talking to you. Go ahead.
Ryan Choptaw. Ryan, one thing I noticed when Bubba Ray and Truth did their spots was that Truth was also had the what's up thing, just like the Dudley's what's up thing. Yeah, talked about that.
At the tables of 3D.
I wanted to get your thoughts about the rumor that Talent and TNA are still worried about TNA's future. They are, man. They are. Not only that, but we've got it in the notes here. I'll kind of mix it up. TNA's current deal with Destination America is a 2-year deal with the option of a third or fourth year. So they're going to be there for at least the next 2 years.
We can ignore. There's two other stories we can tie into that.
Yeah.
A, TNA is about to run Orlando in February, March, and April.
February, March, and April, they are going to return full-time
for one night only tapings.
To Orlando, Florida.
Not the Impact for one night only pay-per-view tapings. And then they are going to do some Impact tapings in March or April, I believe. And then the other one.
TNA's crew also, one more. TNA's crew also flew overseas today for the Maximum Impact Tour. Some of the guys are still stranded here in the Northeast. They will be able to get out either probably on Thursday, I would guess.
And the Bubba Ray Dudley, he asked about that. He did an interview and he was talking about, because for those who don't know, he was at the Rumble and everybody assumes he's back now.
Yeah.
He's not back. That was a one-shot deal, and that's why they jobbed him out so quick. He was only in the match 3 minutes.
They are in talks.
They're open to the idea of bringing him back.
Open to the idea.
Yeah, so hopefully you would assume they'd bring him back, but the question is, would WWE use Bubba Ray Dudley as a singles guy and not like, oh, well, if you get Devon and we'll do the Dudley's thing.
Have
again.
They seen his work in TNA?
You've said it a million times
have
in the past.
They, he's the top heel in wrestling right
You're
now.
You're not going to get an argument with me on that one. I think he would be the best heel they've got if they used him as the
Absolutely.
Bully.
Absolutely.
If you want to call him Bubba Ray because that's an established name, okay, but let him be Bully Ray, call him Bubba Ray, whatever.
Let him be the guy we saw in TNA
and he'd
in
be
WWE.
The top heel. Listen, who's the top heels? Big Show and Kane were the final two heels in the Rumble. Brock Lesnar's not even really a heel. Seth Rollins is the top heel.
Give me, and Boone, give us the Bully Ray that we saw in TNA and WWE and let him be
Give
himself.
Him 2 months, he's the top heel. In the
let place. Him be himself. Let him cut his promos. Give him some leniency
now here's where I was
in those promos.
I'm going to put you over, too.
But if he doesn't have leniency and if it's scripted promos, it's going to be a completely different Bully
and
Ray
here's
than
the problem.
On TNA.
And here's the problem. And there. You always said this. Always. Anybody that ever spent time in TNA, when they come back, they get punished.
They
never
out.
Use them the right
I
way.
Agree.
Even if they're fucking awesome and they
I
should
agree.
Be guys that are on the top.
I agree.
Just because they were in TNA, they fucking don't use them right to be kind of like, you shouldn't have done that.
Right.
You shouldn't have got a job to I feed know. Your family, Bubba. How dare you feed your kids, you fat fucking white boy? How dare you do that to me?
I hope they don't job him out.
They're
I
stupid.
Mean, I mean, Sting is somebody completely different
yeah.
than the normal guy.
But
like
even RVD and
like,
fucking Christian and all these
Sting
guys.
Sting is not the same
Booker
as a Bully
D.
Ray or somebody like that. That's why Sting's coming in
yeah.
and getting a huge push.
And if Kurt Angle came back, he would get pushed.
He
too.
Would get a push,
yeah.
too.
It's, if he could pass the physical.
You've got the upper guys and you've got the mid-cards.
Which, with the physical
they,
thing, it's
they consider Bully Ray.
Kind of interesting. DDP's doing diamond cutters like crazy. And,
I know.
And he must have passed the physical with his old ass.
What do we got here, man?
David Hadley says, triple threat match. Dave Meltzer versus Brian Alvarez versus Ryan Clark. Who wins?
Hey, listen, man.
If we're talking trivia, Dave Meltzer. If we're talking wrestling, Brian Alvarez, because he's actually a worker. People, a lot of people don't know that.
All right.
If we're talking just who's the coolest of the three, got to go with my man Ryan Clark.
I think I'm the coolest of the three, but I can honestly say that...
I was joking when I said that.
I can honestly... Well, I'm the coolest.
I'm clearly the coolest.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
Think about Alvarez.
Hey, listen, you got the back
of
your head on...
Think about Meltzer.
Sweater with Eminem's sweater thing
Listen,
going on.
Listen, yeah. I have always came on here and I say this and I'll say it again tonight. Dave Meltzer is the top source in
easily.
Pro wrestling, easily.
Best reporter
Leaps and
in
bounds
the
ahead
that.
Of Dave Scherer and the guys from
Keller.
PW Insider and
yeah.
Torch and every. Dave Meltzer is leaps and bounds above everybody else. I respect the guy. His
he's
newsletter.
He's our Walter Cronkite. He's the guy.
His newsletter comes out every Wednesday night. He is a very knowledgeable.
F4W Online.
There you
Everybody
go.
Get his newsletter.
F4W Online.
Great newsletter.
Check it out. So
yeah.
Dave Meltzer is one of the most respected guys. So James Lehman, do you think Rollins will cash in at WrestleMania? Also, why Bryan and Sheamus? Bryan Rollins would be better at
like,
WrestleMania.
Looks like they're doing Daniel Bryan, Dolph Ziggler, but maybe that's Fastlane? No, Ziggler straight up said WrestleMania, and Bryan accepted on
okay.
Twitter, remember?
Yeah, yeah today. Today they
so
did it.
So we had heard rumors
Let's go.
That there was going to be Bryan and Sheamus, which they've been trying to do for years, but looks like Bryan Ziggler's where they're going.
Looks like it.
And I like that. If they're not going to use Bryan in the top spot, at least let two great workers tear the house down.
What do we got next from Matt Johnson?
What do we got next from
I recall
Matt
Ryan.
Oh.
You can read
He's
this
talking
one.
To you.
I recall Ryan saying months that WWE will not reach 1 million subscribers. I have all of this.
I know,
man.
But we haven't got through this.
Will not reach 1 million subscribers. I don't
I
think I ever
shit. You think I don't remember
said that. I don't think I ever said
you
that
did.
It wasn't going to reach a
you
million.
Did, you did.
I said when it launched in the UK.
You said because the domestic would go down, the international would go up,
actually,
but it would equal out to like 800-900 at the best, you said. You said it would be
okay.
a year or two before they hit a million, is what you said.
All right, then I was wrong.
So they hit a million in under a year. That's, you know, I mean, they need a free month and all these gimmicks and international edition, you know, so.
No, I mean, they were at 700,000, and then it was going to launch in Canada and the UK.
Yeah.
It would have gone over a
it
million.
It was a free month, and people buying it for their kids for Christmas is what did it.
But it would have gone over a million.
No, because the domestic would have went down, because they had nothing really.
True, it
would have
went down,
guys.
But
yeah.
they still would have. Yeah, you really, know, I yeah. said that it would probably average about a million, but I don't, you know, I mean, they hit a million, but, okay, they're at a million now, and it's launched in Canada, it's launched in the UK, it's in the United States, and they're at a million?
Canada, they got, By the way, the million subscriber count, they're counting the TV
in Canada.
Yeah, those count.
All right, they're at a million. When they first wanted to launch the network, they were hoping for like 3 million.
They were hoping for a million domestic.
Right off the bat. They were hoping for like 3.5 million. They're at a million
in a few years, and they
did all these roster cuts and everything else, but they're at a million now.
Losses.
Got a long way to go, man. And it's launched everywhere now. And they're
not
at a million.
But damn near everywhere.
They're at a million. That's not very good, to be honest with you.
But they did a lot of cuts.
They did a lot of cuts to offset. So they don't need 3 million people anymore. They only need 1.5 million.
Well, it's
something like that.
It's the same way in North America when they first made it available, everybody signed up. But then
right.
the second round, they lost numbers.
Second round, they go down.
So the thing
same
is,
thing.
All right, it just became available in England and Canada, all these places. So a lot of people are going to sign up.
So you're telling me
plus
only
it was the free month, so a lot of people signed up.
You're telling me.
Well, my point is, will it stay a million? Can they keep a million?
So if they were
can
at
they keep a million.
If they were at 750,000 or whatever it was, you're telling me from the United Kingdom, only between Canada and the UK and everybody else, telling me only 150,000, 200,000 from the UK signed up?
The domestic went down, so the international helped.
All right, so 300,000.
The domestic probably went down to like 500 from 700 or 650 or
all right, and you've got Canada,
so you get like 400,000.
300,000. I remember people on Facebook telling me that at least a million more when the
UK. A lot
of
those people were part of the 600,000, 700,000.
Right.
You didn't remember? Like, a lot of people were able to get it even though it wasn't available yet in the UK and England. Also, while we're on that, the stock price, you have that in your notes.
Yeah, it raised
the network.
22% today, which is good news.
It's the highest it's been in a long time. See, I'll tell you right now, if you've got that stock, sell it.
Yeah.
Sell it before it starts going down. It's not getting much higher than that, and if
I'm
it does,
telling
it won't
you,
last.
I've said it, 1 million people for the network, it's not a good number.
That's
man.
My question to you. Will they be able to keep a million? All right, they got there. Can they maintain that
Why
and
not?
Grow, or
Why
will
not?
They go down?
Probably
Tom Nelson says, not sure if you covered this, but is Bubba Ray on full-time?
He is not. David Hadley, do you think WWE crashed their own cancellation page so people wouldn't be able to unsubscribe?
There's
I saw that.
You got in the notes there.
Possible.
Hashtag cancel WWE.
Yeah, you know, I mean, the stock went up today 22%, so it looks like that the canceled WWE network didn't work. Stock going up, million people, and... After the Royal Rumble pay-per-view is where they hit the million people subscribers. So, after the Royal Rumble, subscribers actually went up.
Yeah.
So that canceled WWE Network, it didn't do much good.
Yeah. Well, for those who don't know, after the Rumble ended, there was a big campaign to cancel the network.
Right.
That's what he's talking about. Joseph Gallo, Bully Ray at Royal Rumble, a one-time dealer really appeared. John Morgan, there is no way that it's a coincidence that Vince McMahon says, thank you for 1 million subscribers, just 2 days. After the inner wrestling community starts a cancel the
WWE
Network.
I was thinking the same thing, man.
Yeah.
I thought the same thing. It's not a coincidence that they come out after canceled WWE. I don't know.
We got the next one, too. Thoughts on Justin Gabriel quitting.
Quitting
Anthony Remy, Lesnar versus Reigns. Reigns wins.
Gabriel is going to be with Pro Wrestling Syndicate, though. He's already got his
WWE appearance
booked. So.
We forgot to mention that. Anthony Remy, Lesnar versus Reigns. Reigns wins and Rollins cashes in and wins. He's asking a question, because there's a question mark.
It's possible.
He says, think about the crowd if Reigns wins at Mania and if Rollins was to cash in and win. So there you go. If they boo Reigns, they've got that they can do to get the crowd back.
Rollins is a heel, though.
Yeah, but I think if they hate Reigns so much,
if they hate
like,
him
oh,
so
Rollins
much, right.
got you, you
right.
motherfucker, you know.
Turn Rollins babyface after
that.
WrestleMania.
Let them.
Yeah. Jason Hansen, final thoughts on Silva against Diaz. That's for
this
you,
Saturday,
man.
Yeah.
For you.
Oh, Jason Hayes, final thoughts on Silva vs. Diaz. I also thought the segment was Reigns. Oh, okay, well, we'll start with Silva Diaz. Final thoughts, I got to stay with Silva.
I
want
go
Diaz to win,
but I want Diaz.
I'm exactly there with you. He says, I also thought the segment with Reigns, Lesnar, and Heyman on Raw was very well done, with quote-unquote respect being the main focus of the segment. Do you see it being a match where after Reigns wins, Lesnar shakes his hand and goes back to UFC, passing the torch in the process?
I think Lesnar goes out as a full-fledged heel. I don't.
Normally, if you're going to have him leave, you do the babyface thing. You put somebody over.
Put somebody over on the way out. Yeah. It's Lesnar, though. I don't know. I think Heyman may do a turn, and Lesnar's kind of fuck you on the way out.
That's,
you know what I mean?
That would be the best way.
Heyman
if
does.
Lesnar's leaving, that's the best way to do it.
David.
Heyman stay without Lesnar. He only signed to be Lesnar.
We're going a little bit overtime for you guys tonight. It's a couple minutes extra. We started late tonight. There's no SmackDown tapings or anything like that.
I'll sit there with your hands.
You keep
down
rushing me because you want to get
your hands
you
down.
You said
there.
We're going over.
A lot of stuff that I got to get up on the website.
I do too, cocksucker, and I still got to change my
mind. Well, we're getting out of here. David Hadley, you guys said the fans would have accepted a Ziggler or Ambrose win. Do you think they would have also accepted a Bray Wyatt win? He was pretty over with that crowd, too.
No, and I'll tell you why. He's the guy that threw Daniel Bryan.
Oh, really?
He's the guy that threw Daniel Bryan, and they kind of turned on him from there on.
Right, right.
Vincent Nugent, Acer, says, I really enjoyed those sit-down interviews last night on Raw, the better of the usual norm. What the fuck does that mean?
Speaking of sit-down interviews, Steve Austin, Triple H, podcast.
I can't wait for that.
It's going to be awesome.
Oh, fuck.
What do you think about that, man? Steve Austin, Triple H on his podcast.
Next week after Raw, 11:06 p.m., the Return of the Stone Cold podcast at WWE Network. Last time it was like an hour and 15 minutes with Vince. Time it'll be an hour.
Triple H.
And it was your idea.
Yeah.
As soon as it was over, before we even come on the air, you told
me. And you got to do H and then Steph.
You told me, you're like, yo, they should do that every... And I agreed. I'm like, yeah, they should do shit like that more often. And you said, not shit like that. They should do that more often. Only, like, you can't do Vince every time. Maybe I said, well, who you do?
Triple H.
He said, do Triple H. He's another executive guy. Do Stephanie. Do Pat Patterson.
Steph after that.
I was like, yo, Pat Patterson, Stephanie, Triple H. You're right. They could do Michael Hayes even. They could do all these guys, and it would be great.
I'm always right.
You're always right. They're doing Triple H.
Raw was postponed yesterday, too.
You're right. I told you you were right about that. All right. And
I'm always wrong, and he always fucking calls me out.
But the Triple H thing, man, I can't wait. I can't wait. Yeah. Did you watch the episode?
It's going to be awesome.
You didn't.
Man.
You never watched any of it. The WWE 24?
I haven't seen it.
After Raw last
I want to watch it.
Oh, God, it was
good.
Oh, God, it was good. Oh, all right. Man. You almost want to cry for the Connor. What's his name? What's his name?
Oh, Connor. Oh,
Super.
God.
What's his nickname? Super.
I know the kid that died of cancer.
Yeah. Oh, God, it breaks your heart. Oh, man.
I know.
This is like footage you haven't seen, though. It's like, oh, God, it hurts. It hurts.
Connor
McKaylick, but it's like Super. McKaylick. What's his fucking nickname? Super something.
Oh, man. I don't know.
I don't remember.
All right. What do we got? Jay Mullen. Why do people instantly jump?
Super Crusher, I think.
Super Crusher.
Yeah, the Crusher.
Jay Mullen, why do people instantly jump the gun instead of letting things play out? See it time again from the IWC. You asked this a couple of weeks ago, man. People always jump the gun on the IWC, man.
Impatient wrestling fans.
It's just wrestling fans.
The attitude error is the reason for that. They would hotshot shit so much to get you to change channels.
He says, hell, Clark, you do it quite a bit, man.
He's doing it right now. He's rushing it. People would change channels so much during the attitude error that they got used to the formula of being shocked every week on Raw.
Yeah.
So when they're not shocked and they don't immediately go to what they've got built up,
right,
and they drag it out, people are like, why are they doing it? Why are they doing it?
Right.
They're getting there. Daniel Bryan's going to win at WrestleMania 30, and we're going to go yes, yes, yes. We don't have to do it right now, you know?
Right. Joseph Gallo.
They waited too long on that one.
Up next.
Joseph Gallo says, first, did you notice Roman Reigns, E. Kane? What the fuck is that? When Roman Reigns, Kane, and Big Show, that the bell got rung. What the fuck is he saying? Eliminated, I think, is what E.
Eliminated.
All right. Did you notice when Roman Reigns eliminated Kane and Big Show that the bell got rang? The bell rung. What is
you
the deal?
You can't type eliminated, bro.
What is the deal? I didn't know there was an abbreviation for eliminated. E forward slash, I think is what that is.
Yeah.
Or no, that's a forward slash. What is the deal with fans blocking wrestlers' cars? Is it true or false? I heard that. Again,
it
after
is
you
true.
Told me. Yeah.
It is true. There were a couple of fans that were out there.
A lot of people probably don't know that one. You should
know. They were trying to block wrestlers' cars after Roman Reigns had won
the
Royal
Fargo
Rumble, the actual match itself. They were outside the Wells Fargo Center. There were fans in the back, and basically, there's always a lot of fans.
Autograph seekers.
Pictures. Doing autographs and everything like that, and there were some fans. There were only about 10 or 15 fans that were trying to block cars.
Crazy
but
drunk fans.
They would drive right on through, and it wasn't a big, it wasn't like hundreds of people were out there.
Not a riot, but.
Yeah. It was about 10 or 15 fans that were
blocking
probably,
the exit.
Probably drunk.
Yeah.
Creating some issues, and the guys would
that's
roll
so
down
funny,
their
man.
Guys would roll down their windows and would say, hey, "What's up?"
I wish,
and everybody
I wish you
would
were there
out of the way.
Or an event we go to, something like that would happen, so I could just watch.
It wasn't
like,
as
look
bad.
At these crazy sons of bitches. Man.
Yeah, it wasn't as bad as you know. I guess I made it out to be on Twitter, but there was about 10 or 15 unruly fans that were out there.
Unruly.
And,
didn't see that word coming.
All right. What do we got next? John Morgan. Boston gets no WWE events for months because of a blizzard. Hashtag snowgate. Yeah.
Joseph Gallo. What is the Titan Towers? What is the Titan Towers and where are the Titan Towers located? WWE headquarters is Connecticut.
Titan Towers is WWE headquarters.
It used to be called Titan Sports, so right. The building was Titan Towers.
Titan Towers. Titan Tower with no S.
It was Titan Towers.
Well, it's one tower.
I know, but they call it Titan Towers.
Titan Towers. Jason Hansen, were you guys able to book Josh Barnett? Still got to book that. Jorge Romero, what's your pick for UFC Silver? Diaz talked about that.
So, hopefully Diaz. David Hadley, that's what you get when you vote liberal.
Talking about politics. Anthony Remy, I'd like to say thank you, Matt Boone and Ryan Clark, for the weather updates with post-wrestling news. You need to take a week-long vacation. I do, man. I do.
Vincent Nugent with Justin Gabriel asking WWE for his release. With him could be pro... What?
Let's go on, man.
Could be Pro Wrestling Syndicate bound. Would he have a better fit in Lucha Underground TNA for its X Division, Ring of Honor, or any other major wrestling?
I know what he's talking about. He's leaving WWE. Would it be a better fit for the indie scene? I would say yes.
No, I think he could fit in anywhere he wants. New Japan, he would fit in. Ring of Honor, he'd fit in. Style.
You're right.
X Division,
right.
Lucha Underground,
who's going to play that poor bunny? What about the bunny?
They could get it back to Sami Zayn or Tyson
Kidd. Or somebody like that, yeah. Brandon Brown, where do you guys, where do you think they go with Ziggler now that his push is over before it really began? I don't know that his push is over.
I don't know if his push ever started, first of all, but it looks like they're doing Ziggler-Bryan, which is a step up for Ziggler, step down for Bryan, but it's still a good match that will win fans over, you know?
All right. We'll skip down here to David Hadley again. Will Daniel Bryan... ever get his championship rematch?
He lost the title and he never got an immediate rematch because he had to forfeit. He didn't even lose the title.
Hey, listen, Daniel Bryan came back. Crowd still loves him.
Yeah.
So I think it's going to be another case of the crowd is going to force Daniel Bryan right back to the main event.
Not at Mania.
Not at Mania.
I don't see them doing two triple threats in a row just because the crowd said, fuck you, we want Daniel Bryan.
Right. Not at Mania. It's going to take a while, but the crowd is not going to give up on Daniel Bryan, no matter what.
Clearly.
No matter what.
Clearly.
And they're right back to where we started. So
I agree. Last year, this is the same shit that was going on last year. It's happening again this year.
Right.
They didn't learn.
Vincent Nugent.
Go ahead.
Go ahead.
Is it finally a relief for Canadian fans that subscribe to the WWE Network via Rogers Communications? Can finally now get the online stream for no additional. Why do I keep getting the one with the fucking spelling? It makes me sound stupid. I'm reading exactly what's written. I did not.
Shut up and read it.
I did.
You know what he's saying.
I have no idea what he's saying.
I don't need it.
All right.
David Hadley, the Terminator in the Hall of Fame. Bob freaking Urlacher.
Euchre.
I was talking about Brian.
I should have read that one.
I was talking about Brian Urlacher.
Yeah, that's a Chicago
Bear.
He's
talking about
a baseball announcer.
Bob Euchre.
That's the ball game. All
right.
That guy.
I was talking about Brian. All right. Anyways, does he deserve a Hall of Fame spot more than...
Arnold?
Than the Arnold.
Euchre, the Arnold.
The Terminator.
Euchre did some WrestleMania shit in the early days. Like, Andre did the hand over his face because he had the big hands.
Yeah.
Or, he put his hand right here. And Euchre said, could you get your foot off my shoulder? And then Andre grabbed him by the face. Oh, you don't tell me. So he's had some moments. But,
is Euchre still alive?
Yeah.
He's alive?
All right. He was at the Hall of Fame either last year or the year before.
Yeah.
He's funny as shit, too.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Well, put him in.
Artie Lang and Norm Macdonald will tell a story. You know how he was a baseball announcer, and there's a cough button.
Right.
You got a cough, you hit the button, you cough, and it's not on the air.
Right.
He said he would use it like a jazz instrument. To tell dirty, filthy comments about hot chicks he saw in the crowd. So he would do something like, there's a ground ball to Sosa. Look at the fucking tits on that chick. Three outs. And he'd go right back into the game without even fucking, you know what I mean?
That's awesome.
Perfect, bro.
That's awesome.
So
Last one.
A gangster.
Last one from Nugent.
Vincent Nugent says, Ryan and Matt, what are your thoughts about the whole hashtag Deflategate controversy surrounding New England Patriots?
Ugh.
We talked about that. It's stupid. They're going too far with it. Shut up already, Patriots.
Shut up. It's time for the Super Bowl.
And you're looking at two New York boys,
go.
Right? So we're not sitting here saying, oh, but we like the Patriots. That's why we're sitting here.
You ready?
We like the fucking Patriots.
We're doing quick hits or misses.
I'll let you do it.
I hate the Patriots. They're in my Bills division. I can't stand them.
And you hate the Boston Red Sox?
You ready?
Yeah, go ahead.
I'm going to ask for your comments on these.
Okay.
And then I'm going to chime in real quick.
All right.
WWE Tough Enough returning. Steve Austin. I have another pack of cigarettes.
I already took it.
Okay. Steve Austin, WWE Tough Enough. Is he going to host?
We don't know yet, but I hope he does. And Bill DeMott will be back, yes.
Bill DeMott's going to be back. Steve Austin hosting.
The format changes a little bit. A lot of more live interactive stuff, a little different seasons.
Arnold Hall of Fame. Thoughts?
If it's a celebrity wing, sure, why not?
Celebrity Wing, I
agree. A lot of people are probably influenced by him with the bodybuilding. And
Undertaker, WrestleMania 31, talked about this earlier, but...
Will he be there?
Is he going to be there or not?
I don't know.
I'm going to say yes.
If you're putting a gun to my head, I'll say no.
I'm going to say yes.
I say next year he'll sell out Dallas Cowboy Stadium, and that'll be his retirement.
WWE Network, 1 million. Good number, bad number?
For now, decent number.
For now, bad number. It's launched everywhere. Not big on the 1 million. Finn Balor injured. Was skiing today?
He was skiing today, so it's not that bad.
Not that bad. Bubba Ray Dudley back in WWE. Is he going to be back full-time, or is it a one-shot deal?
They'll get him back somehow.
They're getting him back somehow.
Or not somehow, but they'll sign him and they'll use him somehow.
Raw rating.
Maybe not that
3.2 for a show like last night.
Good or bad? Is that what you're asking?
Pretty fucking good.
Amazing, yeah.
Yeah,
for it was going to be big hour one no matter what, but the fact that they kept that audience for most of it, and it grew in hour two, shows that it worked.
WWE stock up by 22%. Does it stay there, or does it drop back
now? Sell now.
Now. TNA, Destination America, for 2 years.
Unless you bought it today.
It's a good thing. Option of a third or fourth year.
They got a home. They're going to, you can keep TNAWrestlingNews.com around for a while, at least.
Absolutely. Sean Waltman, Randy Orton,
Nikolai Volkoff, Chris Jericho,
all backstage at the Royal Rumble. Yeah. Didn't use them. Had Randy Orton dressed in his gear, ready to go. Why did they do it?
They were trying to swerve the internet, and they were hoping that some of those names would leak so that we would report them, and then I guess people would be disappointed that they didn't show. I don't know what the swerve is.
We had Waltman on the website. We had Chris Jericho possible for the website.
Volkoff was too fucking old to...
Too old to be out there.
Jericho said he wouldn't be in the Rumble.
WrestleMania at 32 in Dallas, Texas. Confirmed?
Arlington's confirmed. Dallas is not.
And WrestleMania 33 likely for Philadelphia.
Likely.
SmackDown Live Thursday night this week.
In Hartford,
Is Lesnar going to be there? He flew home yesterday to Minnesota. Does he come back?
Because they promoted last night that there'd be a Lesnar-Reigns face-off on SmackDown.
Right.
As they were about to set up the Lesnar-Reigns face-off on Raw. So Renee Young's like, oh, this Thursday we're going to have the face-to-face with Lesnar and Reigns, and we're also going to have it tonight here on Raw.
Did you hear Reigns being fed his lines
last night? Yeah, they were
feeding lines. It was so audible. It came across on Raw. You could hear it.
If you really listened, you could catch it.
Daniel Bryan upset at the Royal Rumble. Got eliminated. Got eliminated.
Yeah.
There are a bunch of different
good
fan
actor.
Reports. We got three different fan reports. I even put a video up on the website yesterday. He is a very good actor. He sells injuries.
Well, he's a very good actor, but he's a good wrestler, and he can sell.
He's a pretty fucking good actor with injuries. He used to do it in Ring of Honor all the time, would sell that he was injured.
Yeah.
Everybody would believe him. And then it would come out that he was...
So the story was he looked super pissed as he was heading to the back, right?
He looked pissed, and he even mentioned to a couple fans, I don't know, man, I'm pissed.
Yeah, I can see that.
I don't know. And then the other thing is, tomorrow night's SmackDown is supposed to be the original Raw script from Monday.
Yeah.
So it looks like, or not tomorrow night, but Thursday night, it looks like SmackDown on Thursday night...
You're going to get a mixture of...
lag. It looks like...
That's normal right there.
Is it?
Look.
All right. That's normal.
Yeah.
All right. It looks like SmackDown on Thursday night is going to be Raw, but condensed into 2 hours from three, which is what Raw is. The last thing, Layla. Underwent surgery. Something is up.
For personal reasons.
Something is up with Layla.
Yeah.
Nobody knows the deal. She's been out for quite some time. I got them all. She's been out, unless whatever's over there. Is it Gold
Dust? Maria Menounos Hall of Fame, Gold Dust, Awesome Triple H podcast.
Okay, I got that and that. It looks like Layla, there's something is up with Layla. Nobody seems to know what it is, and nobody has found out anything, but she underwent surgery for something personal, and is going to be returning shortly. Gold Dust?
Real quick, we got the casket match, Daniel Bryan versus Kane on SmackDown's Live Thursday show.
Right.
Fastlane, we've got Sting versus Triple H, the confrontation. And we got Cena Rusev, we talked about that. But the Sting Triple H confrontation is new. We didn't talk about that. They're going to actually do the first face off with each other.
Right.
Until now, Sting's been in the distance pointing a bat. So it's going to be like the first thing with Sting.
Goldust, there was talk that his in-ring career is going to be winding.
He's denying it, but I heard
he denies it. Yeah. He's going to be around in that company for years to come as an agent or a producer.
He's denying that his in-ring career is dying down.
Yeah.
It's
fading
down, which I've heard, even though he's saying that, it's still dying. It's fading down.
Hey, listen, if WWE
says... They probably do the Goldust Stardust Mania thing.
Yeah.
And then that'll probably be it.
Could be a case of Jim Ross, Jerry Lawler, where WWE fades you out, whether you Lawler's want him or not.
Lawler's in the middle of it right now.
Jim Ross didn't want to be faded out from the announced team.
No, he wanted to do NXT with Regal?
Jerry Lawler probably didn't want to be moved over to SmackDown. They make the best of it, and then they're faded out. Goldust, possibly the same thing. Yeah. Maria Menounos.
They asked her to do the red carpet for the Hall of Fame.
For the Hall of Fame. That's it.
So who cares? That last year was Renee Young, but yeah.
That's Tuesday night, and Thursday night into Friday.
You goddamn right.
There may be a snowstorm brewing.
Night, but.
There may be a snowstorm brewing for the East Coast.
It's the beginning of the show, middle of the show, end of the show, weather, politics, oh my goodness, God.
Now, wait a minute.
Spent 3 minutes on UFC.
You're
going to
blame me for the politics?
I said it was my fault, but you took it way further. I kept doing this off camera trying to tell you to shut up.
There were three or four different times. I
started
was trying.
That's my fault for starting. Yeah,
I was
trying. You was going too long.
I was trying to move on, and at least three times you said, "Rygal, call up, man."
I started you up.
You wouldn't let it go. You kept saying, "Rygal, call
I'm
up."
I'm talking about once the phone call started.
There was even one point in this show where you said, "Rygal, call before it's too late."
Yes.
You were begging him to call.
I thought it was gonna be funny.
And then he called.
To hear you two argue about sugar. That's all I was wondering. Sugar tax. I thought it'd be funny. Two guys arguing about sugar tax.
We're talking about politics. There was nothing funny about politics.
Sugar tax. Arguing about sugar tax.
You fucked up.
Arguing about sugar tax is funny.
You
fucked up. Just listen to that sentence. You guys were going to argue about the tax on sugar. That's funny.
That's politics.
It's part of politics.
I get it.
You went and did your run for president. You were trying to get elected for president.
We're going to argue about the tax on sugar.
How stupid
that
is
that? That is hilarious.
It sounds stupid,
sounds
right?
Sounds like great radio.
Yeah.
Sounds like great radio.
Tell me about great radio.
About sugar tax.
Don't tell me about great
Fuck
radio.
Out of
Don't
here.
Tell me about great radio.
Get out of here.
GFS.
Euro.
Yeah, you're
I make good radio, baby.
Clippers.
Mark
Fink. Los Angeles Clippers.
Radio.
What about the Los Angeles Clippers? What about them motherfuckers?
Alberta Clippers.
Oh, Alberto's.
Alberto
Del Rio's has hair clippers. Yeah, all right.
I make good radio all every week.
Yeah, okay.
You're just a sidekick sitting to the left of me. We out.
Guy used to pay me to make sure it was good.
We out.
What's up? We're out.
What?
Yeah.
What?
He can host the fuck out of a show, but if you want to laugh a couple times and have
shit.
You need this guy sitting next to you. Or on the other
this
end of the
This fucking
horn.
Guy right here, his name's Matt Boone.
That's my name.
My
we
buddy.
Need back real quick
my best friend right
here.
Yeah.
Weather Zone.
No, don't push me away.
Weather
like
Zone. No, I didn't.
All right.
I was trying to point. Weather Zone Radio, WZR.
That's pretty good.
They always wondered what it stood for.
Weather
now you know.
Zone Radio.
Now you know.
Now you know. Weather Zone Radio.
Acer gets the credit for that joke. It's a funny joke.
Wants some feedback.
Mm-hmm.
Polish up that beer.
you can get us feedback at Facebook.com/.
I got none left, man.
I got a tall
boy.
Go
on.
I got a tall boy.
Go on.
We each got a tall boy out there.
I got one more of these.
Oh, then you're ahead of me. Yeah. Or behind me, I guess. Facebook.com/ Ryan Clark WZR. Let him know what you thought of his weather reports and his politics. Facebook.com/ Matt Boone WZR. Let me know what you thought about a fun show, at least the parts that I could make fun. Facebook.com/ Ryan Clark WZR. You know I'm fucking around.
Wouldn't be a good show if we didn't get into a big old debate
of course,
at the end, right?
Especially at the end, yeah. We go off the air. These two guys sound like a married couple. I prefer it's like a Vince Vaughn, John Favreau kind of dynamic. I'm the Vince Vaughn guy.
I want to be the Vaughn.
Why? Because he's better looking and not fat? I guess I'm fatter. I could be John Favreau. But with Vince Vaughn's lines.
Four! Vince Vaughn!
That's
this is
some other dude. I'm Matt Boone.
Who?
John Favreau.
John Favreau?
Yeah.
Who?
John
See,
Favreau.
You get to be the Vince Vaughn, and I get to be the
John Favreau. He's a pitch.
The John who?
He's the guy that writes the movies and directs them, and then he does like the little sidekick to Vince Vaughn in the movie just so he can have an on-camera credit and make more money.
John Favreau?
Yeah.
I'm the John Favreau, and you're the Vince Vaughn.
Bro, I'll take John Favreau. He wrote Swingers.
Yeah?
Made. Rocky Marciano.
For Vince Vaughn, I'm George Clooney.
There you go. We're out of here.
Matt and Vaughn.
Me.
This is Ryan Clark.
Him.
CX Tuesday night, 8 to 10 Eastern time on WZROnline.com. They can't go. There we go.